everybody flooding in. How is everybody doing on this fan Sunday? It is a goddamn react day today. Chat. CamDog, thank you for the 5 gifted subs. Double the chat for that. Thank them for the sub. Thank you for the 5 gifted. It's Mac for the sub. Chip, Cherry, RX, MCan, Video, Nick, Joan for the sub. Chat. We got a lot of reacts today, okay? It is also one of, if not the last stream in this stream setup room. I don't know for sure. The plan is to move my streaming background tonight to the new stream room. However, we also might move the setup itself. I don't know for sure. You'll see tomorrow when I go live if I'm in this room or another room. But, yeah. Somebody said, are you excited for lockdown? What do you mean, am I excited for the lockdown? Am I excited for the lockdown? What lockdown? What monkeypox? We're going to have another lockdown? How many cases are in the United States? Dude, you're kidding me. Oh my God, monkeypox outbreak before election. Is this another pandemic? Are you kidding me, dude? I mean, this might be it. Imagine I actually had monkeypox though. No, I don't have monkeypox. Those are bug bites. Those are a lot of bug bites. Oh my God, am I the first case? That would actually be kind of hilarious if I was like the first case of monkeypox in the United States. Patient zero. Yeah, I just stepped in a random bush golfing in Maryland. How fatal is monkeypox? 10%? Ooh. That's kind of high. What was COVID? COVID was low. Outbreaks of monkeypox could kill up to 10% of the people who get sick. Dude. Other lower cases are like 4 in 100. It has flu-like symptoms in skin lesions that could be fatal. Dude. It looks like some alien disease, dude. It's bubbling up the skin like that. That's in the U.S. now? How many monkeypox cases in the U.S.? Since the start of the current global outbreak in May of 22, there's been 32,000 cases of monkeypox, 58 deaths in the United States. As of January 10th, the CDC is no longer updating the case count. So there's not that many. Then why do people think that we're going to have another quarantine? I mean, dude, if the monkeypox spread like COVID did, a lot of people will die. If the death rate's that high. I mean, it's still like, it's not like in the bubonic plague, but it's still bad comparable to like COVID. Canada, there's 164 in Canada. I just want to graduate normally. Bro, that'll suck. That'll suck for people that, like, graduated high school, like, 2021. If they had to live through COVID through graduation, and then they're also going to graduate college and through monkeypox outbreak. That would be terrible, dude. That would actually be terrible. Two years of online school. 2 more years of playing Fortnite and not studying? Sounds good to me. Brock for the sub. Katana for the 2 subs. YNS and James for the sub. Mayo for the 5. Can you react to the Papa V Waffle House video? Yeah, we're actually watching that today. Katana for the 2 subs, Splat for the 3. I started my junior year recently. I was wondering if you had any advice on how to make it more smoothly. I hear it's tough. It's usually the hardest year, depending on what classes you take. It's also the year that most colleges look at. Dude, just time management. It's what I say all the time. Time management. Schedule your shit. Don't procrastinate. You'll get it done on time, and you'll do good. Even if you don't do amazing, you'll still get, like, Bs. Anika for the sub. Jimmy, Maya for the sub. Sushi for the 3. Rizard, Balka, Raze, Peyton, Dreamer, Modern for the sub. Spoopy for the 3. I want to say this week is my anniversary for 3 years of being clean. Dumb in the chat. I remember donating last year in August to appreciate my 2 years. Really appreciate how much you've contributed to people with mental health. I also appreciate the people who congratulated me before stream, especially Scully Foo. Life is worth living. I might cry sending this, but I do genuinely appreciate all of y'all. What a fucking nice message. And congratulations on being 3 years clean. That's a fucking dub. That is a long ass time. Spooby, thank you for the 3. And for the nice message. Chicky for the 7. Congrats. Snelly for the sub, Dex for the 5. Bear for the 1,000, but he's Flex for the 1,000, but he's no. Stewie for the sub, Mac for the sub. Camdog, thank you for the subs again. Dave for the 3. Love the stream. I'm in the Navy. Started watching you in high school. Wow. Joy for the sub, and Kira for the sub. And thank you for your service as well. Number for the 3. I love you, Joe. I'm from YouTube coming to Twitch. I appreciate you. I've gone through so much, and your videos always make me smile. Dub. It's for the sub. I'm glad I'm able to help, and I'm sorry you had to go through a bunch of shit. Rain for the 1,000, but he's watch your VODs, pop it, but I can. My family loves your content. Thank you. All right. Chat, what the fuck was I saying? Oh, it might be the last stream in this setup room. I don't know for sure yet. We'll see tomorrow. If you see me go live tomorrow and it's this background, then we're still here. Otherwise, we're in the other setup room. Anyways, today's reacts. Tomorrow, we're going to be doing random games with chat and random, like, Sims/random game day. Tuesday, I'm not live. Wednesday, we're going to be doing a bunch of horror games at 3. We're going to start going live later and later each weekday, this week, next week, and the week after, until we are back to our regular schedule at 4:30 EST, weekdays, 2 p.m. weekends. Next weekdays, so Monday through Friday next week, we're going to be live at 3 p.m. EST outside of Tuesday. I'm not live. The next week after that, we'll be live at 4, and the week after that, we'll be live at 4:30, and then we'll be back to our regular schedule, 4:30 EST, weekdays, 2 p.m. weekends. But tomorrow is going to be 3 p.m. random games. Tuesday, I'm off. Wednesday is going to be 3 p.m. horror. Thursday is going to be 3 p.m. either unbans or sim games. And then Concord sponsor stream. Friday is going to be reacts at 3. Saturday, I'm not live. Sunday next week is going to be reacts at 2. And then next Monday will be Roblox. We haven't done a Roblox day in a while. Deadpool and Dr. Phil for the sub. If you have any videos you want me to watch, games you want to play, exclamation point Discord. Video session, IBM Share Strap, it's time to find most of the videos I watch games I'd play. So if you have any videos you want to watch games you'd play, I have a video session, IBM Share Strap. I also have a Try Not to Laugh, which we're going to be doing next Friday, which might be closed now, but if it's not, you could also send like short funny video, like short funny TikToks that you want me to potentially try not to laugh at. Barefoot Cargo, thank you for the fucking 5 gifted subs. Thank them for the sub. Thank you for the 5 gifted Katana for the 2 subs. Tyler and Husker for the sub. Anyways, rundown of the. Have you seen the new Deadpool? I have. Rundown of the reacts that we have today. Somebody apparently made an animation for me, so we're going to be watching that. That's like a minute long. Then we have the Wercosco guys video, a Neat Canyon video. For the 300 bitty sheesh log, I'm done with the BS bits. This room, end of an era. I don't know what you're saying. Sheesh log, though, thank you for the 300 bitties. Next video we are going to be watching is a Jubilee video. I haven't watched a Jubilee video in a while. But one of you guys said this in the video suggestion tab. One secret, actually a bunch of you guys did. One secret Trump voter versus 6 Democrats, odd one out. The creepiest kids show, what it was like being gay throughout history. I tried a nuclear war simulation. Never watched Michelle Carr, but apparently she makes some good-ass videos. The game that stole $130 million, Waffle House's disturbing training videos, and creeping people out at Denny's. So we have a W lineup today. W lineup in the chat. Flex, somebody redeemed Cody for the sub. Are we ready to lock in? And again, if you have any videos you want to watch games you want to play, video session, I'm game chat. Talk about most of the videos I watch games I play. Anyways, we got a lot of games we're playing soon as well. Just a little update. I know a lot of people want me to play Hollow Knight soon. We are going to be starting up Alien soon as well. Alien Isolation. A lot of people have been asking me to play. Older game, but apparently one of the best horror games that's ever been made. On par, some may say, with Outlast. AJ, thank you for the 5 gifted subs. Thank them for the sub. Thank you, AJ, the track star 77 for the 5 gifted. So we're going to be trying that out soon. But we also have Casting of Frank Stone that drops September 3rd. I think September 10th or 12th. The new Fears of Fathom drops, so we're going to be trying that as well. Amanda the Adventurer drops soon, second one. There's a lot of horror games that we're going to be playing, a lot of thriller games that we're going to be playing, and a lot of longer grind games. We just finished the Cuphead DLC yesterday. If you weren't there, it was a W-ass stream yesterday. But we're going to be trying out a new grindy game soon. We're not starting out the Minecraft Let's Play until mid-November for the people that are about to ask that. I'm going to be doing a Let's Play slash SMP with like a few other streamers. Brady and Cloak, my two editors, are making a mod pack for me and a server for a few of me and my other streamer friends to grind on. But I usually play Minecraft between November and like March. Sushi for the 5 gifteds. I forgot to do the message to you. First one, I would like to say thank you for being here and making me smile since 2023. You've been my go-to if I need advice. Thank you, Joe, for being there for me. Well, thank you for the 500 biddies, and thank you for the nice message, Sushi. Adele for the sub, and AJ, thank you for the subs again. What about philosophy? Oh, we're probably going to do a philosophy stream, not this upcoming week, but the week after that. I think. We're playing the guilt game next week. Not this upcoming week, because today it's actually this week, technically. Next week, we're probably going to be playing the guilt game that we skipped on. It's like a 6-hour thriller horror. I'm looking at my schedule. We're going to be playing Dreadweight. What the fuck is... Oh, Terra Oakart is the other one that we might play, which is like a 2D horror. And we just played the FNAF 2D horror, which was pretty fun. So we might do a different 2D horror that actually has not necessarily better reviews, but more reviews than the FNAF game. Bryson Psycho for the sub, Hunter for the sub. But yeah, I get all these games from you guys, so genuinely dumb in the chat for the people that send videos in the video suggestion tab. Turn mic up, gain up a little bit, just did. A wee bit. Frosty for the 4. Love your videos, they brighten my day up. Keep it the great work. Thank you, King for the 3. All right, let's lock it in here, chat. Not really first video of the day, first short video of the day, only a minute long. Animating for Jim Art. I'm no Meat Canyon, but enjoy.
That would be hilarious if Grumpy just, like, killed all of them. Can somebody do that?
Is he going to animate Grumpy viciously murdering the other dwarves in Snow White and the Seven Dwarves? I would love to see that. I hope that's what he does.
Can we make a spin-off of, like, I know people do it like Winnie the Pooh, but, like, that would be...
Dude, that Winnie the Pooh movie had terrible ratings, too. It's like whenever they do like vicious spin-offs of like childhood classics, it's always bad.
Like that would be hilarious if like we actually went to go see a Disney movie and then like halfway through.
I want to see them booming in the corner though. What is that? Oh, like Papa Smurf smurfing in the corner with a Batman suit on and a belt around his neck.
Oh, she like the whole plot. That's going the same way as the regular story, and then she opens the door and Angry is just fucking bludgeoning one of them with like a mallet, like actually just murdering like one of the dwarves, and all the other ones are like, oh my god, what the fuck is going on? And then the rest of the plot is just that.
Dude, that would be fucking hilarious though. Also, W Animation, but that would be fucking hilarious. It's a regular ass movie. Snow White's like happy as hell, like singing like a regular Disney song, like ooh, like whistling and shit to the birds. Opens the door. Just Grumpy, just fucking malleting Dopey's head in with a fucking meat cleaver. And then she just goes. And it hits like a record scratch.
Like it's like for like an hour and a half of the movie, you think it's going one way, and then it just immediately twists. Meat Canyon ID unlocked.
Yeah, I actually don't understand how animation works at all. So, how do they make it move? They draw it, but then how does it move? Right? Like the Meat Canyon video, which we're about to watch, like, which some of them he does, like, shorter ones, and then some he does long ones. How does he make, like, a 20-minute animation off, like, 9 drawings? Frame by frame? Bro, how long does that take? Like, how long does, like, a 10-minute cartoon take? Like, how long did it take Meat Canyon to do this? Probably, like, weeks. Like multiple days forever. Tell Muzz to wake up. Nobody has paid out the tank top predictions. Buddy, I don't think anybody gives a shit about the tank top predictions, but I also think they did pay them out. Oh, no, they didn't. It was gray. I'll pay it out. TS for the sub, Mr. Frost for the sub, Limited for the sub, King for the three. All right. Let's lock it in here, chat. And W video. Thank you for that animation. Mr. Frost for the sub, TS for the sub. What's the best smoothie flavor? Just a very base smoothie. Strawberry by itself, strawberry banana, strawberry raspberry. Berry smoothies are the best smoothies. If your smoothie is the color green, I don't want it. If your smoothie has the word kale in it, throw it in the trash, right? I don't want to drink that. Or if there's avocado, like I'll go to a smoothie place with avocado. Buddy, why would I want avocado in my fucking smoothie? Mango? I'll drink a mango smoothie. It's just not my thing, you know? Like, I'll have a mango smoothie. Am I going to order one? No. But if somebody hands me a mango smoothie, am I going to not drink it? No, I'm going to fucking slam it. But I'm not going to order it. There's things that I like more. Somebody redeemed Daisy Showcase. Oh my god, we have to remove that channel point redemption. We have to remove that. I'm going to remove that right now. I can do it, but in the new setup room, there's going to be no Daisy Showcase. But she will make star appearances. She will have segmented star appearances. I could keep probably Eat Dog Treat on. Eat Dog Treat 750k channel points? I'm just going to get rid of that. Why did I make that so expensive? Oh, because I remember y'all were just spam redeeming it, and I ate like 6 dog treats in one stream, and it was pissing me off. So I just made it really expensive so nobody would redeem it. Made it really expensive. All right, hold up. Did somebody actually redeem Daisy Showcase, yes or no? Because I'm not going to go get my dog if somebody didn't redeem it. Duck for the three. Thank you for checking out the video. I'm working on a longer one called Average Joe Bart video. Also, yes, you can draw each move in 2D animation. It's super time consuming. Oh my god. Super of the five. Tune in right as Joe said strawberry banana. Where the fuck did that go? Oh, and I was ripping a strawberry banana vape. Taking it storm for the sub. For the three, would you rather piss hot sauce or shit out of football? Piss hot sauce. Riley for the five. Your asshole would never be the same after shitting out of football. Who's for the $50 dono? Thank you, who's yes for the 50? Tune in, go to high school soon, join the ROTC class. Any advice? Don't make your personality that you're in ROTC. It's cool that you're in ROTC, but people will make fun of you if all you do is talk about how you're in ROTC. So don't constantly just be like, yeah, I'm an ROTC, it's a hardcore program, like, because then people are going to make fun of you. But again, time management, focus on your, you know, classwork early, and then you'll be able to do other shit that you want to do. Riley for the five. Been watching your streams every day for a year and a half. Inspired to be more philosophical. Appreciate life for your huge inspiration. Thank you for being an awesome content creator. Well, thank you, DC, for the three. Here's money since I missed last few streams. Just finished my first week at a trade school. Dub. TS for the sub, Mr. Frost for the sub, Tell Mods away, I already read that. Limited for the sub, King Diffy for the three, Psycho for the three. Kitchen for the three. Would you rather be convicted for murder you didn't commit, everybody in the world, including Brooke, thinks you did it, or have actually committed murder and nobody will ever know it was you? So go to prison for the rest of my life? Buddy, that's a horrible fucking hypothetical. Am I allowed to kill, like, a serial killer? Or do I just have to run up to a random person and kill them? Like, you have to give more detail on this, hypothetical here. Dumb for the three. I'm quarantined. My mom made me a ginger smoothie to fight off COVID. Well, dude, I hope you feel better. I gotta go get my dog. Counting down 30 seconds. She just got shaved. That cut's insane. Yeah, she's bald. No, she's not bald. She just shaved. 992 for the sub. Done for the three. All right. Yeah, she got a fade. Not a very good fade, but she got a fade. Anyways, lock in for the next video here. That might have been the last Daisy showcase that's not a special event, right? Low taper fade. It's so bad. Buddy, it doesn't matter. You think Daisy cares about her fashion? Somebody redeems Scream. I would turn down your mics or your headset. Well, there we are. Pray for the three. My name is Cole Harden. Is it okay that I'm extremely gay? Yeah, I don't really care that you're gay. It's not. I don't really know what you want me to say to that. Is it okay you're gay? Yeah, I don't really care. Hold up. All right, lock in. Pray for the three. All right. We're Costco guys. Lock in. Lock in. Reacts today, as I said. Maybe new setup room tomorrow. Hence the No More Daisy showcase. But Tuesday, a new stream, or tomorrow, 3 p.m. EST, as I said. Random games with chat, random games in general. Random game day. Tuesday, off. Wednesday, Scary Game Day, 3 p.m. Thursday, Sim Games Baby on Bands, 3 p.m. 5 p.m., we're going to be doing a Concord stream. Friday reacts at 3. Saturday not live. Sunday reacts at 2. Next Monday, Roblox at 4. And then we're going to slowly just stream later and later until we're back to our 4:30 EST weekday, 2 p.m. weekend schedule. Lock in. Lock in. We're Costco guys. Costco. Oh my God. Wannabe for the three. My dad shaved my dog and now she has bald spots. Does she have a medical condition? Or your dad just messed up the shave? Kitty for the five. Your streams make my shifts bearable. Thanks, Joe. Well, thank you for the five, and I appreciate the nice message.
Oh, guys, of course we go shopping while eating a chicken bake.
We're Costco guys. Of course we get the double chunk chocolate cookie.
Is a chicken bake really all that, though? I've never had one. Like, are they actually fire, though? They gotta be. They look good as fuck. Like, the outside of a chicken bake looks really fun. I've never had one. Well, I don't go to Costco. I don't think I've ever stepped foot into Costco. I've stepped foot into a BJ's. CNC for the sub, which is just like a Costco. But, like, because why the fuck do I need to go to Costco? I don't know. It's just like, Costco's like one of those wholesale food markets where you're buying, like, fucking 65 eggs. Like, bitch, when do I need that much? Or, like, 10 pounds of cheese for, like, pennies on the dime. I'm like, well, when the fuck would I need that much cheese? Sam's Club is better. I understand. It's good for big families. Well, yeah. If you have, like, a family of five, yeah, you go shopping once a month there.
We're Costco guys. Of course we have to try the new double chunk chocolate cookie.
That was great, Dad. Costco! I'm gonna try and work here when I'm older! Get an even better discount!
Wow, that's a dream job. Working at Costco. You ever see when they interview kids and they're like, what do you want to do when you grow up? And half of the kids will be like, work at McDonald's. Because they don't understand, like, that the McDonald's workers make no money and the job blows and shit like that. Bro's nipples? Yeah, dude, he does have some fucking protruding nipples. I used to say I wanted to be a soda truck driver because I loved soda. And so I was like, yo, fuck being a doctor or an astronaut. I used to be like, I want to drive soda places and make my own soda flavors. And I still think that would be pretty fun. Are there soda trucks? Yeah, you've never seen like a Pepsi truck? They just deliver soda. They're just truck drivers, but they just deliver soda for like Pepsi or whatever company they're delivering for. Ham for the sub, Frosty for the six. This is the real Cole Harden, not saying it's a bad thing, but I am in fact not gay at all. Love the VODs. Well, thank you for telling us. You know, I don't think anybody in chat knows you, so if they thought you were gay, I don't really think it matters, right? I don't think you're going to meet somebody 5 years from now that you would want to, like, date, and then they would be like, aren't you Cole Harden from Joe Bart's Twitch chat? I heard you were gay. Like, CNC for the sub. I don't think it's really going to, you know, thank you for changing the confirmation, right? Like, okay, you're straight now. That's fine. Either way, you're gay or straight. I don't really care. You're doing you. That's all that matters. But I'm just saying, you know, you didn't really need to follow up and change the statement. Anyways.
You know we live for...
Somebody said play the video, holy shit. God, take for the sub. Oh my god. Oh, you just started following yesterday. Buddy, all I do is yap on the stream. Oh.
The discount, son.
Hey, it's Cole again. Is it weird I like feet? Bro, stop asking me these stupid questions.
I gotta show you something new Costco has. It's way in the back.
Sure! What is it?
You'll find out, son.
Oh, wow! I've never been back here before!
Are they gonna kill the Costco kid?
This!
Alright, so you're giving away one child.
Yeah, one kid. Yeah.
Okay, that upgrades your membership card for another 10% on cash rebates. There you go.
Oh, yeah! That's a boo, baby!
No!
Oh, yeah. Oh, he's a big boy!
Stop! Come
here!
Is this some kind of joke?
Whoa! Whoa! Hold him! Lift with your legs!
Get off me! What is this? Daddy!
Set it down.
Daddy!
Here.
Daddy!
Long day.
Help!
Now move this pile over here.
Dad, help me! Oh, God!
Yeah, you're no good. More in the back.
Where are they even taking him, though?
Close it.
Daddy!
He does a TikTok. He takes out his phone. He posts on the AJ and Big Justice channel. All right, guys. So my dad sold me into slavery. All right, so my dad actually ended up selling me for a 10% rebate on his Costco card. I still do think the chicken bake is a boom, though.
Veo algunos hombres. Creo que nos están apuntando. Quizás nosotros somos los siguientes. No dejaré que te lleven, te lo prometo.
What? Hi. He's gonna go. What? Do you like baseball? Do you like the chicken bake too? How do you get here?
I don't speak Spanish. I don't know what you're saying.
Everything will be okay.
That's definitely not what he said in Spanish. Oh my god. Yo, he just talked for like 15 seconds straight. You think he said everything will be okay? Day three, stuck in a Costco packaging facility.
I don't know if I'm ever going to make it out, but I've been able to puncture one of the boxes and just been eating double chunk chocolate cookies for the last 3 weeks. It's actually, I can't tell if it's been 3 weeks or 3 days. I've gained 155 pounds. I can't walk. But these double chunk chocolate cookies really are a boom. It's really hot in here and the chocolate melts and the cookies taste even better. I don't know if I'm going to be able to make it out of here live, but I'll keep you updated.
Damn it, Mikey. Hey! Help me! Help! Help! Hey! No! No!
I just keep thinking about that last chicken bake I enjoyed. Would it be my last? I don't know. I'll keep you updated on the next one, guys. On the next Boom or Doom video. Brought to you by The Wizzla. That fucking kid. Like, yo, it's honestly, that's my whole For You page, just brain rot. The Rizzler just going, I hate the Rizzler. Now, I don't hate the Rizzler, but, like, that's his whole thing, is, like, that he's the Rizzler.
Ini seharusnya putih dia. Menurutku ini dia.
Wah, Tuhan. Lihatlah dia. Babi kecil ini terlihat seperti
sudah. How long has it been?
Mati. Dia akan baik-baik saja. Kita akan melatihnya dengan baik.
Oh my god, they're getting the cacao beans for the double chunk chocolate cookies.
Jangan malas-malasan. Balik kerja, saya malas.
Sini. Yo, I honestly, like, I'm trying to imagine, like, IRL Big Justice or AJ getting thrown into a cacao bean, like basically like human trafficking ring where he just has to consistently just cut and peel fucking cacao beans for the double chunk chocolate cookies. Oh my god.
Let me call my wife.
Somebody said bros and Oompa Loompa. I don't think, are Oompa Loompas willingly working for Willy Wonka? Like, do they want to work for Willy Wonka? Like, lore-wise. I feel like, yeah. In the new movie, they're friends. But that's also, like, a fucking musical. He saved them. Yeah, but now they just work at a fucking chocolate factory all day, every day. Where else would they go? I don't know. What a fucking dumb question. What do you mean, where else would they go? Anywhere.
Please, I have to use the restroom. Sekarang cepat. Kita harus penuhi kuota.
Hey Ahmad, kamu harus kesini. Ini sangat lucu. Lihat seberapa besar kue ini.
Oh, kuenya besar banget.
This double chocolate cookie is a boom! Isn't that right?
Lihat, gimana tuh sama dia?
Ya ampun, ada apa dengan yang kecil
lucu
itu?
Lucu banget.
Kenapa
ini orang.
Kenapa terlihat seperti itu?
Oh my god, it just ended. Are they gonna do a part two there? Or is it literally just gonna end off with Big Justice's is Big Justice the kid or AJ the kid? I don't know. AJ's the kid. Big Justice is the kid. AJ's the dad. If are they going to do a part two, or is Big Justice just forever working at a cacao farm now? For the three, are you going to play Block Wars again? They started a new season, updated all the games. Yes. I just couldn't in the last one because I wasn't streaming. King for the three, but next month I would. Magic for the three. They work for Chocolate. Dominator for the three. World of T-shirts. Got Monkeypox. Look at their TikTok. Why for the three? You hear about monkeypox? Yeah, we just talked about that. Pandas for the three. Today's my 18th birthday. Happy birthday, bro.
Been watching for 3 years. Really love everything you do. Favorite streamer. Thank you. The thing for the three. You're my favorite YouTuber. I'm also a YouTuber. Can you shout me out? No. King for the sub. Gamer for the three. I don't do shout-outs for money or in general because then everybody asks for a shout-out. It's kind of like a thing when you're in school and it's like, hey, you know, if you bring a donut for one person, you got to bring it for everybody. It's kind of the same thing. I appreciate the support, though, but I don't do shout-outs. My apologies. King for the sub, gamer for the three. What is this? Joseph for the three. My brother delivers soda for Kirk. Also, the Twitch update is terrible. Naomi for the three. Well, on the phone. Do you have tips on making friends when you go to a new school? Just talk to people. If you don't talk to people, you can't make new friends. You know, you gotta just walk up to people that you think you might, you know, be interested in hanging out with. Hammond, take for the sub, for the three. It's cool again. Oh, wait, I already read that. Aqua for the three. The Costco kid isn't relatable to the older guy. Isn't related to the older guy. Wait, what? AJ and Big Justice aren't related. I thought he was the dad. Oh, the Rizzler. Well, yeah, the Rizzler's not. We know that. Brody for the three. Umpalo Bros work for them willingly. He pays them in cacao beans, which is their favorite food. He saved them from monsters from Loompa Land. Some call me a Willy Wonka lore connoisseur. But isn't he somewhat manipulating them, right? When you're thinking about it, the Oompa Loompas are working, like, I don't know, probably 10 hours a day for $30 of chocolate. Like, if he paid them currency, they would be able to buy more chocolate than, I mean, he also gives them a place to live. So, yeah, they get electricity and fucking bedding and other shit. All right. Aqua for the three. First actual video of the day. One secret Trump voter versus six Democrats. Odd one out. Haven't watched an odd one out video in easy 6 months.
I'm a Democrat.
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 Do Oompa Loompas have sex? Oh, like asex, right? Are they like asexually reproducing, or are there guy Oompa Loompas and girl Oompa Loompas? Because when you watch the movie, they're not really, like, there's no sort of, like, indication that they're, like, there's, like, married Oompa Loompas. CC for the sub. There are no women Oompa Loompas. The guys reproduce with guys. Well, but at that point, then they're just asexually reproducing. Then they just clone, then they bud, like potatoes. The thing for the five. Will you play Fortnite on stream if I donate 1,000 right now? No. I would play Fortnite on stream another day. Not today, though. Today's a React Day. Dominator for the three. I think they're being held against their will because do you ever see an Oompa Loompa outside of the factory in the movie? No. That's what I'm saying. I agree with you. That's what I'm saying. They might not hate the situation they're in, but they don't know the better world. I was for the sub. It'd be like a moderately happy North Korean person. Like, they're still being, like, kind of shunned from the outside world by Kim Jong-un and his regime. They might not know. They might not be, like, physically unhappy, but they're still being blocked out of a world that they know nothing about. Hold up. Sorry, I'm responding to Brooke. All right. I was for the sub. Anyways. What was I saying? I don't remember what I was saying. What was I saying? Oh, Fortnite. Yeah, I would play Fortnite. Did they update Fortnite yet? When are they updating Fortnite? I would play fucking Fortnite tomorrow if they updated the Fortnite season. Should we try the new season? Is it good? What's the new season like? Dizzy for the three. They made a secret where Willy Wonka has to fight for the chocolate factory after OSHA found out the ceiling of the hallway is too short. Their living conditions weren't up to OSHA standards. She keeps asking. She keeps texting me, and I'm saying, Brooke, I can respond, but I can't respond in length. I'm streaming. She goes, okay, sorry, you can go. I go, okay, love you. And then she immediately just asks me another question. Dominator for the three. In some of the versions of the story, Oompa Loompas were far more villainous than they are in the published version of the novel. They were shown to actually kill children and use body parts for their candy. What? The fruit for the sub. Dizzy for the three. I think that'll be fun to watch. All right. Next. X Drake. Pew. Jeff. Ratman. Your boy. It's Craig. Nye. Caden for the sub. Dominator for the five. Absolutely ruined politics. I think we should get rid of parties. Everybody runs independently. I don't think that would get rid of politics, but you can't just get rid of parties because if you get rid of parties, people are just going to say, oh, I'm running. And then they're just going to be running under not the Republican Party or the Democratic Party, but something similar. I think the two-party system is terrible. I don't think parties are bad, comparably. I still think, yes, somebody running as an individual would be best, but then you're not going to be able to get support or, like, you know, donations and votes out there to be able to get your name out. But I think the idea of just having the Democratic and the Republican Party being the two main ones that obviously go to head-to-head is horrible. I think even just, dude, if we just had one more party, just a third party, re-scrub, redo the entire Electoral College. It's never going to happen. I'm letting you know that. It's never going to happen. We're going to die before it happens. But you re-scrub the entire Electoral College, have three parties. Just like in, oh my God. Taiwan, right? I think Taiwan has a three-party system. Or four. Yeah, Taiwan originally had two camps, the pro-unification KMT, People's First Party, and New Party forming the Pan-Blue Coalition, and the Democratic Progressive Party. Yeah, having three parties, I think, is usually better because then it enables you to not just be like, oh, I'm one or the other. There's going to be, like, another option. And, you know, that might not be the best thing as well, but it at least gives you more variety to where people aren't just slotting themselves in one or the other. Nully for the sub. The Creepiest Kids Show. Can you explain communism from your point of view? Economically or socially? And by what country? Can you copyright Joe _ Bartolozzi streams? I don't know. Maybe. I mean, yeah, probably. Do that many people think that accounts me? People do sub to them. Yeah, that is a problem. I'll message my manager about it. Maybe get him banned. I don't know. I don't have a problem for, like, waiting rooms, but this guy just streams my shit consistently. I message my manager. All right. Nully for the sub. He has mid-roll ads? Yep, and we're going to get it banned. And now we're getting it banned. Also, my chat says they run ads. And now we're going to get it banned. Yeah, if they're running ads, I'm getting it banned. I thought they weren't making money from it, but if they're running ads, accepting subs, they applied for affiliate, obviously. Yeah, no, we're going to get it banned. All right. I don't care if, like, they're just, like, oh, a waiting room and they're not making money. But, like, they applied for affiliate. They're running ads. And, yeah, they say don't sub in chat, but people still do anyway. Red for the sub. No. Just trying to make money off my videos. The Creepiest Kid Show.
Scared. In fact, they're the opposite. They use.
How do you know they applied? You don't auto-get affiliate. You have to apply for affiliate. You will get accepted. But if you're a streamer... And then there's if you start streaming, there's no sub button. You can't make money. You have to have a certain amount of viewers to make money. You have that amount of viewers, you have to apply for affiliate, and you have to fill out a tax form. So they applied, right? They openly went, I'm going to try and make money from this, and then went, okay, I'm going to apply for this. Yeah, no. And then you apply for partner as well. Gary, for the $25 dono, said missed the stream yesterday because I was at a funeral for a church member. He was 46, ripping the chat. I'm sorry for your loss, man. Red for the sub. And your community's loss as well. Fox for the three. You see the new Marvel Fortnite season yet? No, but we might play it tomorrow. Is it good, Fox? Do you like it? I'm actually going to do a poll on that as well. And I might go pee real quick. Do we do new Fort season tomorrow? Yes or no? It wouldn't be for the whole stream. It would just, it's because it's going to be a random game day tomorrow. We could just like start with Fortnite or do it randomly. Be up to y'all. Chat, I also got to piss real quick, so count me down 30 seconds. Thomas for the sub. All right. Lock in here. All right, some people voted yeah. All right, we'll do a little bit of the Fortnite season tomorrow. Thomas for the sub, Fox for the three. It's generally fun. There's a little skill gap to learn the new jetpack item. I've been playing ZBEs a ton, so if we ever run it back, I'm primed. All right, word. Bye for the sub. I might try it out tomorrow. I don't know for sure. But it is a random game day tomorrow, so I might try it. All right, lock in.
Kid shows aren't normally...
Oh, creepiest kid show. Forgot about it.
Kid shows aren't normally something that's supposed to be scary. In fact, they're the opposite. They're usually the most bright and happy, sweet and kind pieces of media you could find in the world. But sometimes, there are kid shows that are a little darker. Ones that traumatize you. I remember back in...
Mr. Fucking Meaty, dude. Mr. Meaty's the weirdest fucking kids TV show you could ever watch. It's not even close. There's like actual cannibalism in that show. And they're puppets. And puppets are creepy. Super for the three. I want to get into streaming. Do you use Streamlabs or Stream Elements? I've used both. It's whichever one you think is better for you. Will and bye for the sub.
Elementary school around
or just OBS studio.
Halloween time. My teacher decided she would put something on for the class to watch. She had done this before, so we were all excited. I was
Jess for the 1,000 minutes said, can you check out this TikTok? Oh my man. Are you German guys? All right. Lock in.
I was excited. We all sat in rows on the colorful rug, crisscross applesauce, everybody's knees touching. And she rolled out one of those old big TVs, the ones that give you that fuzzy feeling when you touch them.
Loved those, though. Back in, like, first grade, it's about to be Christmas. Second to last day before break. The old teacher rolls out this motherfucker, pops in a fucking DVD or a VHS tape of, like, I don't know, the Grinch, the original Grinch, and you're like, dude, this is about to be crazy.
I was stoked. I was excited to see SpongeBob.
You sit on your carpet spot, and you're like, dude, I am locked in. Absolutely locked in right now. We had projectors. Yo, did any of y'all have, this would have been, like, first grade. But when you were learning, like, base math in first grade, It wasn't a projector. It was this weird thing that would project an image, but they would put it under a light, and it would shine on the light, and then, like, it was, I don't know what it was called, though. What was that? What was that? We had that for art. What was that? What was that called? Promethean board? I don't think so. No, it was like a old yellow thing. And they would roll it out. And it would reflect. Reflector school. School math. What was the thing they used? It's an Elmo. It's called an Elmo. Oh my god, it is. Oh my god, it's actually called an Elmo. This. Do y'all remember that? It had like a little square image and a magnifying glass. And the teacher would put whatever they wanted to show the class under it. And then it would project onto the screen. I feel like they used those for a while. They used those into like 2010, dude. 2012. They used those for a while, especially if your school was poor. Like, I remember my school had that for a long time. And then we finally got, like, a shitty smart board. Jesse, I already read that. Thank you for the 1,000 biddies, though. Outcast of the sub.
Or Shrek, or whatever it could be. But when she turned on the TV, it wasn't Shrek or SpongeBob. It was Goosebumps. Some of y'all may have forgotten or may just be too young.
I used to read Goosebumps and get scared. I don't think I ever watched the Goosebumps movies. Or not movies, the show.
But when I tell y'all this show used to give me nightmares, I mean nightmares. So today, ladies and gentlemen, I'll be facing my fears. And I'll be going over some of the episodes that were buried deep, deep in my subconscious with y'all. And in the end, I'll go over the episode that scared me.
Actually, I did watch this episode. I remember this episode with this doll. Easy for the 25. Thank you for the $25 donut down in the chat. I love all your VODs and streams. I watch many of them high, and they always make me laugh. Well, thank you for the fucking nice message. Thank you for the fucking 25.
The most as a child. So strap in. Starting with the one known as the scariest to the general public. And this is when we follow these two girls who stumble across this novelty shop in the middle of the night. And straight off the jump, turn around and go home. Please. These two girls are Sabrina.
PWR for the three. I go to a Catholic school and the message was about TikTok and he was talking about you and Mr. Beast. I was laughing the whole time. This is the mass streamed. It's at 30 minutes. Can you send it to one of my mods? Because I can't click that link. So if you're able to send it to any of my mods, they'd be able to send it to me.
AKA the main character.
Your pastor was talking about me and Mr. Beast at mass.
Character's best friend. And our main character, Carly Beth. What kind of name? In typical horror fashion, our main character is fascinated by the novelty shop and wants to go in. I mean, it has scary masks and an ominous man watching them. Who wouldn't want to go in? But before she can even take a step into the shop, her best friend Sabrina tells her no. Thankfully, that's a good friend. But after they leave, we see why Carly Beth was so interested in those scary looking masks. You see, Carly Beth is constantly being bullied in the form of people scaring her. These boys from school, her best friend, her little brother, all be scaring her because she's a big, big scaredy cat. And honestly,
and instead of getting a mask, you carry around pepper spray. And then when somebody scares you, you spray them in the fucking eyes, you mace them, and then they won't scare you again. Because they know you have pepper spray. Somebody said Oregon. Well, then you would probably kill them.
Relatable.
Which would solve the problem, but then you would be in prison.
Anymore, but I used to be the most sensitive, easy to scare kid on the face of the earth. And let me tell you, crime.
And then you would have many more problems.
Crying at every horror movie gets old. And it was starting to get old for Carly Beth, too. The next day at school was the last straw. During lunchtime, the two boys that scared her from the night before come over to her table to apologize, saying they were just joshing around, having some fun, but Carly Beth was not having it. She tells them, whatever, just go away. But when they go away and Carly Beth takes a bite of her sandwich, she notices
there's actual fucking shit in it. They pull one of the meanest pranks ever and just give her a sandwich with an actual fucking turd in it.
This PB&J is a little more chewy than normal and tastes a little like...
Worms. She was eating a tuna sandwich. That's already, bro, the worm ain't really making it that much worse. Tuna sandwich, the worm's just kind of adding to that, you know? It's not really changing much. Dominator said, are VIPs allowed to send links? I mean, if it's the link that that guy sent, yeah, but otherwise, no. Yo, Joe, you're such a W streamer. Watch all your VODs. You're the first content creator I spent money on, so honored. Love. Thank you for the fucking three. Keen.
Live worm in her Penny. Sandwich. Man, that's not even a prank. That gotta be some form of attempted murder, because what the actual... This was the last straw for Carly Beth. She had been humiliated. Her self-esteem was destroyed. She was so mad.
Yo, that motherfucker laughing way too damn much.
Her self-esteem...
Yo, he's banging the table. Yo, he literally cackling and knee slapping right now. She been into a worm, bro. This ain't a comedy special. It ain't that funny.
Her self-esteem was destroyed. She was so mad.
And pointing at her. Yo, that would actually annoy the fuck out of me. Say there was a funny prank that was, like, played, and my friend just starts slapping the table and pointing and open-mouth cackling. I would go, dude, are you from a fucking 1999 Disney movie? Are you a real human? What are you doing? You're pointing and laughing. What? Len Braun for the three. My brother died about a year ago. I'm sorry to hear that. We used to talk about you, and you reminded me so much about him. Well, I'm sorry for your loss, man. Len Braun, thank you for the three. And I hope the mourning process is going well.
Mad, she destroyed her duck costume. It was getting serious. She wanted revenge. She was tired of being the one who's constantly scared. She wanted to finally be the one doing some of the scaring. So she goes to the one place where she knows she could find something scary. The novelty shop. Carly Beth gets in and is met with this creepy old dude who, although is hesitant at first, lets Carly Beth shop around. My dog. Carly Beth browsing around and she's not really rocking with any of the masks. They're not scary enough. Conveniently, though, she finds this back room that has exactly what she's looking for, a scary mask. But when she goes to grab it, the old dude comes out of nowhere and tells her, nuh-uh, these masks are not for sale. Carly Beth persists and tries to get him a watch.
Then why you got him up on fucking display, dickhead? See, like, it's not even just Goosebumps that does this. Like, I know they ain't in, like, the regular storeroom, but if you ain't selling something... Maybe put it in, like, a drawer or, like, a safe in the back. It's in the back? Okay, it's in the back, but still. Like, he has them on display.
See, Carly Beth persists.
Like, if you're that worried about people buying them and their haunted masks, maybe don't keep them in your mask store.
And tries to give him a whopping $30. Hold on, $30? But the old man still says no. Come on, dude, $30? That's like a meal at Chick-fil-A. What are you doing? Old dude tells her she's not ready for responsibility of the mask and it's super dangerous. But while he's explaining, Cardi Beth steals the mask and runs out. She's a thug. And
for no security for the masks either. Masks that have fucking supernatural capabilities. And they're just sitting on a stick in a back room that is unlocked.
For some reason, the old dude doesn't chase.
That'd be like just keeping a loaded gun on a table. And just like, hey, you can take that if you want it.
Hey, sir, he just yells and closes the door? I mean, Carly Beth finally got what she needed to get revenge on the bullies. But
yeah, he really didn't try to get that shit back. Also, no way she'd be able to outrun his ass. Maybe he's like 65, but still. In a 40-yard sprint, you got about 4 steps. You just kick her in the shins.
But she was going to regret that real soon. Carly Beth gets home and immediately puts the mask to work, scaring her little brother. And that was only the beginning. She suits up for Halloween, taking with her this weird replica of herself that her mom made for her. I don't know. And picks up Sabrina to go looking for the bullies. She's hunting. And this is where we notice the mask is making Carly Beth act a little...
What a realistic mask that looks like Carly Beth with no body. Those bullies are definitely going to fall for this when they see a fake plastic head on a stick and then try to fucking scare her from behind.
A little more peculiar. Y'all like that word? Y'all like that? She's more aggressive, scaring.
Oh my God, I think somebody decapitated Carly Beth. Her head's on a stick.
Random kids, scaring random moms, and even scaring Sabrina. Sabrina confronts her about this, and Carly Beth's only answer is, the mask made me do it. Okay, so if you grab me like that again and I punch you, just know my fist made me do it. Carly Beth eventually runs away for some reason and stumbles upon exactly who she wanted to find. The bullies. And a perfect setting too. She approaches them and they're immediately wetting their pants. Talking about how they was just...
Why is she carrying around the head of herself? What is the purpose of that? She just like has her head on a stick, but there's no reason she has her head on a stick.
Goofing around, and they only did those things to Carly Beth because they liked her. Oh, how could we all be so stupid? The old worm.
Oh, it's supposed to be decapitated.
I'm in the sandwich move, eh? Real panty dropper. Forgot about that one. Carly Beth successfully scares them off after the replica head of herself whispers to the boys, "Help me." And Carly Beth afterwards buries the replica head and returns home. I'm sure at this point some of y'all already know what's going on, but it gets even clearer when Carly...
Oh, is Carly Beth's soul trapped in the head? And now the ghost controls her.
Beth gets home and is finally ready.
Yo, I watched a scary movie yesterday. Y'all ever see The Boogeyman? The new one? Good-ass movie. Those motherfuckers are dumb as hell. Dumb as hell, dude. Oh my god. I saw that, and then 2 days ago, I watched the original Alien. Dumb as hell. Dumb as hell. You're telling me you got Alien running at you, and no one tries to, like, burn it or just open an air duct and put on a space suit. Like, what are we doing here, dude?
Ready to take off the mask. But when she tries to, it hurts. She can't seem to take it off for some reason, so she asks Sabrina to help her. When Sabrina goes to check, she sees there's no line between the mask and Carly Beth's skin. She even runs to the bathroom and sees the eyes in the mirror aren't her eyes anymore. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, she has become one with the mask. This was insanely scary as a kid. Getting stuck as your Halloween mask? Heck nah. It's bad enough that it's this mask, because let's be real. If you were stuck looking like that, you are...
Just cut it off. Again. Dumb ass motherfuckers in every horror genre ever. Dude. Seriously. Like, I'm watching Boogeyman last night. If you don't know Boogeyman, it's basically like a monster that hides in the dark slash closets, and it only can kill you in the dark. But it, like, haunts people that have, like, fear and trauma and are, like, weak, right? Like, that's, like, the whole point of the monster. And the kid in the movie... Hold up. The kid in the movie, annoying as fuck. I gotta pull up a photo. Boogeyman movie 2018. Bro, is it? Yeah, this kid, annoying as shit. Like, low poly fellow, who gives a shit? She carries around this dumbass light ball all the time, right? And the house is always dark. The house is never lit, right? They're in a home in a modern society, right? The older sister has an iPhone, right? So we're not in the fucking 1800s. Oh, it's her skin now? Okay, whatever. Anyways, I'm ranting about this movie, so I don't give a shit about that. And basically, the boogeyman's trying to kill her, and it's like this fucking 8-foot monster that's really creepy. I'll fucking show you a photo. Oh, it's 2021. What is the boogeyman movie? The boogeyman movie 2023. Oh my god. I didn't know it was that new. The monster's, like, really, gross and kind of looks like it smells like, rotting bodies. That's the monster. And, dude, it'll, like, slam open her closet and she'll go, oh, and grip the stupid light ball and it'll run under her bed. It'll run under her bed. And you know what she does? She leans under the bed and lets go of the light and rolls it and is in quite possibly the most vulnerable spot she could ever be in, where she's just staring under the bed and then it jumps out at her. It doesn't kill her there. Another time, she's getting her tooth. This girl's already telling her older sister, who's like about to graduate high school and also like getting bullied and shit. Their mom died in a car crash. Whatever. Anyways. The younger sister's like, hey, I saw this really creepy thing. And the older sister goes, okay, I'll help you get rid of your tooth. So they tie her tooth to a fucking string and tie the other string to a door. And the sister, say this is the doorknob. The sister's standing like this. And she goes, okay, on three, I'm going to close it. And she goes, one, and the door with the might of Zeus by itself just slams shut. No one touches it. The door slams shut, and the girl's tooth gets ripped out. And this bitch, who's probably 17, 18, perfectly capable of recognizing, you know, whether or not there's a monster in the building, goes, oh, that was weird. And then that's it. They don't look into it. They don't do anything. The younger girl goes, I thought you were going to count to three. Bet you were staring at the door just like she was. Nobody's going to talk about how the door just shut on its own. Nobody's going to talk about that. And then this bitch. Oh, my God. I can't take these movies, dude. I don't even remember her fucking name. Dumbest motherfucker in the whole movie right here. Ding, ding, ding. Idiot. She sees this ghost. She sees the boogeyman nine fucking times. Barely escapes with her life every time. Tells no one. And until the sixth or seventh time, she tells the younger sister that she's a liar. So she's like putting down her like six-year-old sister, saying, no, you're just seeing things. You're just emotionally traumatized right now. When she also saw the monster, and they take her to therapy. I gotta show you the scene. If I'm able to show you the scene.
There's nothing to be afraid of, okay?
They get this red box. They take her to a therapist. They give her this red box. And the therapist, creepy as fuck, goes, all right, the box is going to blink. And it's going to just stop blinking at some point, and it's going to get really dark. Okay? And the kid's like, all right. Ends up pissing herself. Because this is what happens. It keeps blinking. No one's paying attention. And this is how the therapist is looking over them, mind you. Wide-eyed. Smiling, whispering, weird as fuck. And then in the corner, she looks up. Oh, they don't even show it. And sees the boogeyman. And it jumps at her. And then they flip the lights on. I'm like, you gotta be fucking kidding me. Right? And then, oh my God. It's just like, and then there's this scene where, like, right at the end, she's fully had it. Right? The daughter, and this is the real cake on the fucking icing, right? Or the real icing on the cake here, backwards. The dad, oblivious, right? He's a therapist. Fucking dumbass. The young daughter is playing like some fucking old like GameCube game or some shit. And the boogeyman's hunting her. And so she's just alone in a room playing a video game. And she's like silent, just sitting there. Right? And the dad and the older sister know she's playing video games. Out of nowhere, the boogeyman comes up, grabs her, and throws her full force into the television, knocks her ass the fuck out, and cracks her head open. They go to the hospital, and the dad doesn't bring up how that happened. So, is the dad just thinking that his six-year-old daughter just full sprint and then fucking pancake jumped into the fucking flat screen TV going 15 miles an hour from a fucking 6-foot gap? And then the daughter goes, oh, the boogeyman's real, right? Dad, the boogeyman's real. The boogeyman threw her into the TV. And the dad goes, are you high? And that pissed me off, right? Right there is where I'm backhand slapping him and going, you gotta be fucking kidding me. And I'm shaking his head and saying, lock the fuck in, right? But the boogeyman's real. The boogeyman's real. Right? The boogeyman's real. The only time where you could, like, forcefully shake your parent and go, you're a dumbass. What is wrong with you? Right? Anyways, holy shit. The daughter just goes, fuck you, and leaves. And I understand her frustration, but it's like, why not just try and convince your dad for, I don't know, maybe 20 seconds that the boogeyman exists? The dad goes back to the home with the daughter, gets fucked up, gets both of his legs snapped. The boogeyman just throttles this motherfucker. If you've ever seen a 6'5 guy fight somebody that's like 5'2, that's how this fight went. Just absolutely pummeling the ever-living piss out of this guy. And then they end up saving him by lighting him on fire. There's the movie. You've seen it. You're welcome. It annoyed the shit out of me.
Not pulling a single person. Like, just scratch having kids off the list, please. But I think if it was one of those random funny masks, it'd be even worse. Like, imagine just trying to trick or treat one year, your mask gets stuck on you, and now you're stuck as the 44th president of Barack Obama or something. Like, I ain't signed up for this. Carly Beth runs back to the novelty shop where the old dude is waiting for her, and he explains to
that would actually be scarier than this mask. If somebody was hunting me with a random presidential mask on, that would be way, like, if somebody had, like, a Bill Clinton mask and they were chasing me, that would be so much more scary than, like, this.
Sir, that's her new face now. Carly Beth understandably starts tweaking out, but the old man interrupts her and tells her that there might be one last chance to remove it with a symbol of love. Self-love. He starts explaining to her how he was just like her and he didn't love himself. Blah, blah, blah. This ain't about you, bruh. But before Cardi F can know what a symbol of self-love is, the other masks start floating off the shelf. This may look goofy, but you gotta understand, as a kid, this stuff was scary, bruh. Floating heads chasing you. Come on, buddy. Be real. It's a little scary. The heads chase Cardi Beth all the way back to the cemetery where she buried her replica head, and they start backing off as soon as she raises it up, accepting that the crybaby scaredy cat girl she tried to bury is her, and she should love her regardless. Cardi Beth is finally able to take off the mask. Woo! Yeah.
Yo, what a dumb episode. Holy shit.
Yeah, all right, let's go. Yep. She goes home and hugs her mom, who had been worried about her all night. And while they're talking about Cardi Beth's night, they turn around to see the little brother wearing the mask. Boom. And then the episode ends. Pretty scary, huh? Pretty scary. I don't know why she didn't just burn the mask and throw it away. But that's the one deemed the scariest to the general public. That's still not the one that...
Damn, having that one on would be like...
To the general...
The worst. I'd rather wear the creepy one than that one.
Public.
That's like a quadruple chin.
That's still not the one that I found the scariest. But before I go over that one, I have to go over one that I found almost as scary as the scariest, but for a different reason. Unlike
the cuckoo.
Unlike most Goosebumps episodes, this one doesn't have
a cuckoo clock,
possessed mask, or a werewolf, or anything like that. So you're probably wondering, what makes it so scary? In this one, we follow a boy named Michael, whose life might be worse than Cardi Beth's. Like Cardi Beth, he's constantly being bullied, but instead of it being some boys, or his best friend, or his little brother, it's his little sister. Sorry. And obviously, since she's the sweet, innocent little sister, she can mess with him and never get in trouble. Michael was sick of it. He wanted some payback. So the day his dad came home with one of those old big clocks and told his sister not to touch it, he saw an opportunity. He gets up in the middle of the night and makes his way.
It just fucking hits that shit with a sledgehammer.
Way towards the clock. And when he gets there, instead of doing, you know, some actual noticeable damage, he just slightly turns the head of the bird that comes out the clock, which is, yeah, that'll show him. But when Michael wakes up the next day,
his head is facing the other direction.
Things are different. Very different. It's his birthday. Mind you,
no, it's not.
His birthday had already passed. Like, it was a few days ago. So you know what that means. 2 B-days. Hey! Michael had gone back in time. And this is what I meant when I said this episode is scary for a different reason. Because every time Michael wakes up, he gets younger and younger. Going from a tween to a kid to a baby. That's scary. And it's not like when he turns into a baby, he's back to having baby thoughts. No, he's just Michael with the mobility of a baby. I would hate that. Even at my lowest of lows in life, I never, ever wanted to revert back to being a baby. I got too much left in the tank to stop. And it wouldn't have just stopped at being stuck as a baby. Next day, he would have been back in the womb. The day after that, back in the sack. And eventually, ceasing to exist, which is essentially death. Sort of. Luckily for Michael, though, he realized the way to prevent himself from getting any younger was to turn back the bird's head that he messed up earlier, effectively saving himself.
That was it. He just had to turn the fucking bird's head.
From having to go back in the sack and essentially death. Sort of. But like I said, although this episode is scary, it's still not the one I found the scariest when I was little. This title belongs to no other than The Night of the Living Dummy. In this one, we follow a girl named Amy.
Well, dummies in general are always scary. Like, that alone looks fucking creepy as shit. Or, like, any dolls. Like, y'all ever used to sleep at your grandparents' house in, like, that one guest bedroom that had a bunch of creepy fucking old dolls from, like, your parents? Like, a Raggedy Ann from, like, 1975. And it's just sitting there just, like, just staring.
Amy, and unlike the other two protagonists before her, Amy has no bullies or anyone she wants to get revenge on. Nothing. Just an older and younger sibling, making her the middle child, so no one likes her. And she's definitely the most unique out of the three, too. You see, Amy's into the...
No, my grandma was normal, but I think it's very common for grandmas to have that shit. And then it's like that noise, too. Oh, my God. What makes it all worse? The clock ticking noise. This. It's like 3:45 in the morning. You wake up, and there's just like a Raggedy Ann doll just like in the corner of the room like this. And you swear to God, you just saw it move. Like, it just went like that. Like, you're looking at it, and you're, like, dead silent. And it goes like this. Some shit. And you're sitting there like, oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. You're just tripping yourself out. Fuck, dude. I hated that.
Very, very random hobby that is ventriloquism. That's when people use dolls to talk and pretend like they're not talking. And you could have learned how to juggle or something. And one day while showing off her skills, her doll Dennis falls apart. Ah, bummer. Guess you gotta find something else to do. But luckily for Amy, her dad got her a new doll. A dummy named...
That would kind of freak me out if I had like a 10-year-old kid and they got into like ventriloquism. I'd be like, What's the hobby here? Why are we? you wanna make dummies talk?
Slappy, but unlike Dennis, Slappy is no regular doll. You see, after Amy perfectly reads some Latin text that comes with Slappy, it turns out he's alive. And this stupid, ugly doll is the sole reason I couldn't watch this episode as a kid. For some backstory, I was already scared of dolls as a kid because of Chucky. So when I saw another evil-looking doll that likes to crack jokes and he's ginger, it brought back trauma. I'm not gonna sit here and act like Slappy was doing the same things Chucky was doing. He wasn't murking people or anything. But he was doing something that as a kid could be perceived worse than death.
I feel like Slappy looks scarier than Chucky.
He was getting Amy in trouble with her parents, messing up family paintings, making fun of her family. He even attacked a family friend. And all these things may seem tame, like no big deal, right? But imagine if Amy had immigrant parents. Yeah. After Slappy doing all these things and trying to murk Amy's dad with a guitar, my fault, Slappy, I didn't know you had it in you. Amy decides to finally get rid of Slappy by throwing him down a drain. And he does this funny scream when it happens. But that very same night, Slappy
just crawls out of the sewer,
turns, threatening her family and telling Amy she will be his slave forever. Yeah, you could try saying that to her, Slapster, but try saying that to me, and you're gonna end up trending on Twitter, buddy. At this point, Amy's sister finally sees that Slappy's actually alive, and they also realize Slappy is a doll, a hollow doll that you could, like, push over.
Yeah, and that you could actually kick the shit out of.
Over and kick and stuff, which kind of makes my fear of this dude coming after me as a kid a bit irrational, but whatever. Slappy chases them around the house, eventually catching them off guard and tripping Amy. And as he was standing over her, talking about how the family belongs to him now or whatever, two things didn't make sense to me. One, why is the sister just watching him stand over Amy? And two, why is Amy so hell-bent on grabbing the broom to attack Slappy? You literally just shoved him upstairs. Kick the dude, bruh. Anyways, while Slappy is standing over Amy, out of nowhere, someone tackles Slappy, causing him to shatter his face on the fireplace, releasing the evil gas in his system. What the? Amy and her sister are confused as the family comes downstairs, including her brother.
Yeah, I'd be worried the gas would, like, infect me.
Wait a minute. If the brother wasn't the one who tackled Slappy, then who did? We see on the table, Amy's old dummy Dennis is alive, and they gave him the voice of Goofy for some reason.
Gosh, it's good to be back in the family.
Boom, and then the episode ends. Slappy eventually returns and
I'd kill the other dummy too. If any doll came to life, I'm killing it. I'm I would just be like, I might interview it and then just immediately go, this can't be happening.
Again, in Night of the Living Dummy 3 with freaking Anakin Skywalker. Then he returned again in Bride of the Living Dummy where Slappy gets a shorty. And eventually returned the third time in the movies, but...
Yeah, he doesn't look as scary in that one.
That Slappy sucks. Sorry, not sorry. Hopefully you guys can see why I find this show so creepy as a kid. And if you don't, I don't blame you. There's a lot of goofy bones. And moral of the story? Anakin, wait!
That was a good ass video. All right, next. Isabel Rose for the sub, Merite for the sub, Deck, Joshy Yak, Bear for the sub, NXT for the sub, Aiden E for the sub, Truly for the 5. Sent a dono a while ago. It's my birthday. Happy birthday, man. Hope you have a good birthday. The Bart for the 3. Just got off a 60-hour work shift. Haven't been able to catch the stream all week. Happy to be here. About to pop a 700 milligram edible. Holy fuck. 700? All right. What it was like being gay throughout history. When are you playing Siege again, said Tyler. I mean, I played Siege with Zeusy on Thursday. Probably not for a bit. Today's Reacts. Tomorrow, I'm going to be live at 3, probably at the new setup. Maybe. I don't know for sure, though. We're going to be doing random games, the new Fortnite season, games with chat, sim games, Drug Lord Tycoon, stuff like that. Tuesday, I'm not live. Wednesday is going to be horror games at 3. Thursday, I'm doing... probably more random games and then Concord. Friday's Reacts at 3. Saturday, I'm not live. Sunday's Reacts at 2. And then next Monday is going to be Roblox at 4. Next Tuesday, probably not live. Next Wednesday, horror games. But yeah. Do we want to start Alien Isolation this Wednesday as well? I don't know. Because there's a lot of short horror games that we could play, or we could start like a long survival horror. You guys have just been spamming Alien Isolation. How long does that take? 18 and a half hours? I feel like I want to look up like a YouTube playthrough. Is it that good of a horror game? Because motherfuckers have been recommending it nonstop. I don't know, dude. Like, y'all have been recommending it, but I feel like y'all wouldn't want to watch it. Like, low-key. Like, I feel like I'd get one stream in, and people would be like, switch. Switch. People are voting yes, though. Chat, vote on the poll. I don't know. It looks like, it doesn't look bad. It just looks like very survival-esque, more so than horror. I don't know if we'll do it this Wednesday. I'll probably sit on it for a little and see if I want to do it this Wednesday. Or another day, rather. I already bought it. But I already pre-jacked the buy because it's on sale for like $8. So I was like, I kind of need to buy it right 18. Now. Or like $5 I bought it for. Yeah, it's normally $40. I got it 80% off. Maybe. We might try. Are you going to play Hollow Knight? Yeah, we will. I don't know when, though. Probably not this month. Just because we got a lot going on in August. And then early September, we have Casting of Frank Stone and the new Fears of Fathom and other stuff. So we might start Hollow Knight, like, second or third week of September. If y'all have any videos you want me to watch games you want to play, though, videos, just have you have. It's how I find most of the videos I watch games that I play. So if you have any videos you want me to watch games you want to play, send those there. Wills for the sub. What it was like being gay throughout history.
Fellas, I'm not gay, but other people are gay. Really gay, in fact. And people also...
Should I scan this if he's going to be showing random photos? Nope, we're good.
Existed in the past. So a percentage of those in the past were gay. Whatever happened to them? Now, I was expecting this video to...
It is weird how being gay went from being normal to bad to normal to bad to normal. Like, in, like, Greek-Roman times, a lot of people were fucking people of the same sex. Like, a lot of people. Skip, please. I don't care if you don't. I don't want to watch this. What is with y'all being a bunch of fucking, like, weenies, dude? Like, actually, it's a 7-minute video, and I'm 12 seconds in, and motherfuckers automatically get mad as fuck. That actually just pissed me the fuck off. We're going in sub only this whole video now. If you don't want to watch it, fuck off.
To be a 10-minute bloodbath of how every single civilization was extremely homophobic, but it turns out really depends on where you specifically go. Like, take for example China, which has many records of homosexuality in the annals of their history. Get it, guys? Annals, because
mods, run a poll on whether or not we skip.
They're gay?
Like, it's a short ass video though.
Yeah, okay, whatever. Anyway, there's a specific story which dates all the way back to the Han Dynasty of China, when the Chinese Emperor Ai and his lover Dong Xian were in love so much that one time they slept in the same bed. And when Emperor Ai woke up to see that Dong Xian was on his sleeve, instead of waking up Dong Xian and getting him to move, he cut his own sleeve off. This is a really cute story and all, but Emperor Ai also had a wife who probably did not find the whole thing really cute. I'm just kidding. A Chinese emperor usually had multiple concubines, and it's assumed that in the roster of the baddest Chinese concubines for the emperor, there was also a couple dudes in there as well. As time passed, though, attitudes started to shift.
Yo, the weird shit about certain Greek times is it was normal to be gay, right? That's not weird. What was weird is that older men would be mentors to, like, young teenagers that they would have sex with. And then they would, like, teach them and shit. It's like, it'd be like a 45-year-old man would, like, mentor, like, a student, but also, like, they would, like, fuck. And men and women did it. Like, a woman would have a younger, like, girl to mentor, and an old man would have, like, a young guy. And it was just like, and then they would also maybe have a wife or something like of those sorts. A
mixture of Central Asian and Western influences, plus the
I don't need to know that, bro. I mean, it's historic.
The fact that dudes fucking dudes does not result in any offspring that could be heirs to the throne started to cause male concubines to become less and less popular. And the last dynasty to have records of male concubines was the Song Dynasty. By the time the Qing Dynasty took control, acts of homosexuality were a punishable crime, with any gay actions causing 1 month of prison time and 100 heavy blows, which does...
You give your homie a kiss and you get bludgeoned in the head 100 times for fucking kissing a guy?
That sound rough, but was apparently the lightest punishment in Qing legal code. And honestly, from my perspective, if the government outlawed straight people having sex, and then you told me Ice Spice was down to smash, but I would get a month of prison and have gotten my shit kicked in, I'm not gonna lie, I'd be behind bars within the hour. Or 3 minutes. Anyway, the punishment seemed like a cakewalk compared to the Aztec punishment. Sad Catman. What was the Aztec punishment? Good question. The Aztec punishment was honestly pretty grim. Any two Aztec men who got caught shucking each other.
But it's so weird that just the idea that there were punishments for being gay means that being gay was common. Like, people having gay sex was so common that they said, we're gonna make a law against this. Because if it was, like, one dude, then they're not gonna, like, put it into, like, written down things of, like, this is the punishment for that. Like, it was so common that, like, guys and girls were, like, fucking people of the same sex that they were like, all right, we're gonna bludgeon you if you kiss a guy.
Corn would immediately be sentenced to death, and the person on the receiving end of the arrangement got the most severe punishment.
Wait, what? Oh my god, they get their... Wait, what?
Pretty grim. Any two Aztec men who got caught shucking each other's corn would immediately be sentenced to death, and the person on the receiving end of the arrangement got the most severe punishment Aztec society had to offer. And keep in mind, this is the most severe punishment coming out of the society that sacrificed 20 to 250,000 people per year.
Yeah, dude, cutting a fucking live person's heart open and then fucking holding it beating to the sun.
year. So what was in store for the bottom? Well, basically, if you got caught being a bottom, they would imprison you, rip out your colon, which I'm not even sure how you get just the colon out, and then they would burn you alive. But fear not, gays, because just out of the Aztec territories, being gay seemed to be generally accepted. In fact, there was so much gay stuff going on around the time that the Spanish first landed on the Americas. A conquistador named Cortez wrote back to the King of Spain in a letter which said, "We know and have been informed, without room for doubt, that the indigenous people practice the abominable sin of sodomy," which is old-timey speak for indigenous people doing butt stuff, gay butt stuff. So you could see from the letter that the Spanish were not keen on the gays, and so to stamp out any homosexual activity, the Spanish took any gay that they caught to public executions or getting torn apart.
What the fuck, dude?
By dogs. Pre-colonial America was not the only gay civilization, though. So was ancient Greece and Rome. In fact—
But see, that's what's so weird is, like, dude, if you go, like, back to, like, ancient times, dude, fucking gay people, it was normal, right? Like, nobody was like, yeah, we're gonna punish you for being gay. Like, in Roman times, didn't they have brothels where, like, they had brothels regularly, but you could also, like, go and, like, fuck a dude. And that was like normalized, but then somewhere along the lines they were like, no, 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 and then it just like got fucking shot off into another direction.
It was a tradition called pederasty. The idea was that there would be a relationship between two men.
Oh, this is literally what I was talking about.
One was an older, socially higher class person, and the other was a younger, adolescent teen. And although it really depended from city-state to city-state, in general the practice was widely accepted. If you were the older guy, the younger guy, on the other hand, who was usually the receiving end of the relationship, was treated poorly because, well, to be honest, their idea of being gay isn't really the same as what we consider being gay today. Like, from my understanding of all this, if John and Josh are in a relationship today, they're both equally gay. But in ancient—
Oh my god, no. Wait. Was it John and Josh equally gay? But in this, Josh is gay and John's straight. No.
In Rome, if John and Josh are in a relationship, but John is the one receiving, then he'd be the one that gets all the hate while Josh—
Oh! So they still might have perceived being gay as wrong, but because he's submissive, he's more gay.
Josh would be treated indifferently. So I guess ancient people just really hated the bottoms of the relationship. The Aztecs weren't too keen on them either. Anyway, a system similar to pederasty was also found in Japan in the two places you'd least expect, in monasteries and in samurai culture. It was the same idea of an older, usually higher socially ranked man having a relation with a younger, usually adolescent teen. Although there wasn't the same hatred for the younger man in Japan as opposed to Greek or Aztec culture. The samurai one was super random to me because, I don't know, I just never heard of any gay samurais. But homosexual relations seem to be kind of ingrained.
I mean, I don't think it was common in historical text to be writing about a samurai and be like, yo, this one was super gay. This samurai, by the way, he was a samurai, but he was also super gay. Right? Like, that's not, I don't think that was just, that's probably why you didn't hear about it, if I had to take a guess.
In samurai culture. Just like the monasteries, there'd be an older, higher class samurai, and then a younger adolescent boy who was kind of like a student. Now, the relation didn't have to be gay, it really could have just been like a teacher-student thing, but other times, if both parties agreed, there would be a relationship. And other places were also surprisingly open to homosexuality. In India, gay people were pretty common, and were even written about in the Kama Sutra. And Thailand's love for ladyboys is not just a recent trend, with references to gay people dating all the way back to 800 years ago.
Well, religiously as well, in Thailand, being trans, oh my god, see, I'm gonna butcher the shit out of this, but in certain religions in Asia, denying your base human aspect is something that's kind of not pushed for, but like praised, in the sense that if you're trans, you're recognizing the fact that what you're born as may not be who you actually are.
Although, I guess all these gay people shouldn't be too surprising for a country whose capital city is called Bangkok. Anyway, that's not to say every civilization was gay-friendly. I already touched on the Aztecs.
We're not skipping the video. There's literally a minute and 40 seconds left.
But there was also the Assyrians and certain Germanic tribes who did not seem to be a fan of the whole gay thing. So overall, if you found yourself being gay in an older civilization, you'd be good, as long as you weren't the bottom. I mean, there was a wide variety of ways that gay people were treated in the past. Because while the
Were there no switches in ancient times? There were no dudes that were receiving and giving?
Aztecs were absolutely brutal. In other cultures, gay relations were so widespread, it was literally ingrained in the culture. But obviously, in more recent history, there was a lot more homophobic sentiment. Even in
Somebody
some of the
said, "Lol, dom or die."
countries which were more accepting of gay people in the past. So
literally though, I mean, either if you're in the Aztec culture, they'd kill you either way. But
happened. Well, it usually comes down to one main reason. Usually it was an outside influence, whether that be a religion or just culture, that shifted a previously more tolerant culture into being a homophobic one.
Like, for example,
there was a homophobic sentiment in Abrahamic religions. And so as these religions grew, specifically Christianity spreading to Europe, so did a homophobic sentiment. And then when a Christian Europe took over pretty much everything, they exported their culture, and with that, the homophobia with it. And now I'm not saying that Christian...
Wow, dude. So if, like, Hinduism spread instead of Christianity, there would not be as much of a historical struggle for LGBTQ people.
Christianity and Islam were the sole reasons that there was a change in attitude. And there definitely was other factors to this. Like Zoroastrianism, which is a super old religion, was partially the reason that India first started to become less tolerable to homosexuals. And for the Chinese, it was Central Asian cultures like the Mongols who shifted how they felt about gay people. And some cultures like the Aztecs came to their own conclusion that gay people were ass. But by and large, when a place was influenced by Western culture, homosexual acceptance decreased. So, there you have it. I hope you enjoyed. Consider liking, subscribing, all that. Goodbye.
Well, that was an interesting video. Next. I tried a nuclear war simulation. This is the first Michelle... How do you say her last name? Video, but apparently she makes like some high quality ass videos, so let's give this one a watch. You guys have recommended a few of her videos in the chat, or not in the chat, in the video suggestion tab recently. So let's give this one a watch. Carrie or Michelle Care. I don't know how to say it.
Nuclear missiles are incoming with 10 minutes until impact.
This is an attack.
Yo, what y'all doing if they say there's 10 minutes left before a nuclear bomb, right? Like, you're literally just, like, chilling, watching a show right now. Right now. 10 minutes. Nuclear bomb's hitting your city. What are you doing? You're killing yourself? Well, that's a little pointless. You know? I mean, you're gonna die in 10 minutes anyway. Call my family. I think that may get Taco Bell. I don't know if you're gonna be able to get it in time. Do mushrooms. They wouldn't even hit. But if they go 10 minutes, you pop the mushrooms, yo, it'd be like 10 seconds left and you'd go, I think I'm starting to feel bang, and you would be disintegrated. I think I'm starting to feel something. Boom, just immediately obliterated. That'd be like, I'm gonna eat an edible. Buddy, you ain't even gonna feel that. And they nuke me, I am spamming that nuke button back at them. That is the whole reason nuclear bombs work, is because if I have a nuke, that's bad for you. But if we both have nukes, then we don't kill each other, right? That's why the nuclear submarines are so valuable, because it's like, say North Korea does decide to bomb us, we level their country. Everyone in North Korea dies. Every single citizen in North Korea will die. And they know that, right? Kim Jong-un knows that. If Kim Jong-un shoots a nuke at the United States, every single person in North Korea dies, including him. And then his country is just gone, right? So that's the, yeah, mutually assured destruction. It's the idea that it's like, hey, if we all go, we're going to make these nukes, but if any of us ever use them, we're just all going to die. That was a WF video. All right. Next. The game that stole $130 million. We're probably going to have to say, okay, chat, we're going to be able to watch both of these, but we're going to have to cut one. We're keeping the Papa Meat video. Which one do we want to watch today? The game that stole $130 million or creeping people out at Denny's? We'll be able to watch both of these, but this video is 35 minutes long, so that's, and with my yapping, that's going to be like an hour. The Fern one. Mods, can we do a poll? Can we do a poll? I'm actually going to go piss as well while we run this poll. I have to go piss. Oh, my God. All right, count me down 30 seconds. What did people vote? The Denny's one? All right. We'll do the game that stole $130 million another day. Let's do... Do you want to watch creepy people at Denny's first? No, let's watch the Waffle House first. Julian Golden for the sub. All right. Lock in. Waffle House is disturbing training videos. You guys have been spamming this in the video session tab. And I love Papa Meat, so.
Welcome back to the Papa Meat channel. How you doing? How you doing? Come on in and sit on down because today...
What happened to the boxing guy? Tomorrow or... It's either tomorrow or Wednesday I will be at a new stream setup room. So I've been moving stuff slowly. I was going to just move the background today and then stream with an empty background tomorrow. But I'm thinking if I have time, I might move my setup as well. So we'll see.
We're talking about dangerous jobs. The dangerous job we're talking about today, ladies and gentlemen, is being an employee at Waffle House. For those of you who don't know Waffle House, let me give you an idea. Let me paint you a picture. Maybe it's 9 p.m. Everywhere else is...
Not 9 p.m. It'll be like 3 a.m. 3 a.m. You're either high, drunk, or you're just, you know, really fucking hungry. And you're like, hey... Where could I go get a bite to eat? Breakfast sounds really good right now. And then you see a glowing business, and it says Waffle House, and you see two workers inside. Oddcats, thank you for the 10 gifted subs! Thank them if you got a sub, thank you for the fucking 10 gifted Oddcats, you goddamn goat, thank you for the fucking subs. I appreciate the subs, Oddcats. I don't even know how many you have to the channel total. 2,042, wow. Thank you for the fucking subs. All-time number two gifter. Dub. Anyways. Yeah, you see those Waffle House lights? You walk in, there's two people fighting in the corner. Somebody's getting a maple syrup foot job in the other corner. You wedge yourself right at the bar, right at the front seat. The worker, who looks like they haven't slept in 6 weeks, walks up to you and says, "What do you want?" And you get a waffle. And as they're making your waffle, right, you look over and the kitchen is covered in grease and shit. It is disgusting. The kitchen is horrifyingly gross. But then you get your waffle, and it's the best waffle you've ever had. And then you leave that joint going, huh, maybe Waffle House isn't that bad. And then you go back again another day. YX for the five. Lover Show, hope you're doing well. Fade as fuck eating Wingstop. Dude, hope it's good. Thank you for the five.
Close. All you know, you're like, we can't go to Chili's, right? We have to go to some place where we can grab a quick bite. You go to Waffle House. It's a Southern Midwest restaurant chain that is open 24 hours a day.
Fucking love Waffle House. Fucking love Waffle House.
That primarily sells breakfast items. Doesn't seem all that dangerous, but for some reason, America has cultivated it as the official stomping ground of the states. I don't know why it's been dedicated as the primal pit, but it has. It didn't always start that way. In fact, actually, it was founded in 1955 by Joe Rogers Sr. and Tom Forkner in Georgia with the vision of creating a fast food restaurant with table service in a friendly atmosphere. Boy, oh boy, did they really, they missed the mark on that one, okay? Ironically enough, they ended up making, dare I say, the most dangerous restaurant in America. Sure, there's brawls and like McDonald's and stuff and fast food chains because there's a billion of them out
there. Dude, but like whenever you watch a Waffle House brawl, it's always some drunk motherfucker at 4 a.m.
there. While Waffle House only has 2,000 locations, it is small enough to feel claustrophobic, but it's big enough to really rustle and tussle. It's the perfect arena size. You go to McDonald's to film prank videos. You go to Waffle House to draw blood. That's the delineation. Fuck around and find out at a Waffle House is what they say. And luckily, ladies and gentlemen, we have a little tip from the inside. We've been leaked videos of how they indoctrinate these gladiators, these warriors, to be able to withstand the onslaught that awaits them.
I never thought there would be a training video for Waffle House employees. I just assumed that the other employees that worked there would train you and then you would just work there.
All right, first one up.
Like, it doesn't seem that, like, you need that much training, right? Like, you gotta, if you're a cook, you need to learn how to do that, but it's like, it's just like a base, like, waiter job.
Waffle House training, the pull, drop, mark, order, calling method. My objective here is to get you guys feeling like you could do this job. So let's see what we can do here.
Hi, my name's Kevin, and welcome to Waffle House. Just as a little tip, if you ever see the man, don't approach him, but make sure he gets the food that he wants.
I want to say the music.
And then the music starts back up.
If Bob ever comes in and asks for a sirloin medium well, give it to him. On the house. Or he'll actually eat your soul. He'll kill you. He will kill you and your whole family. You'll go home and everybody will be dead.
Music is extremely deceptive to how the actual experience is going to go working in a Waffle House. I've never been in a Waffle House, no matter
what. Never look a customer in the eyes. They get aggravated.
A time of day where it has ever felt this calm and peaceful before. Never. Not once. Even when I was a child and I'd go there with my grandparents, the aura that Waffle House has cannot be matched by any other restaurant.
Yeah, it is a little stressful in there at any time of the day.
I don't know why that is. It just is. Wait! Today's video is sponsored by...
Oh my god, I thought it was going to be that sex toy ad.
Hello, my name is Greg Hall. Today we're going to discuss the pull, drop, mark, call-in system.
Greg Hall's been through the ringer. I want to say Greg Hall maybe had a couple drinks before this, and they're like, God damn it, Greg, and they had to comb his hair. Come on, Greg. And he's like, what? I'm the area vice president. What does that mean? Area vice president?
The pull, the drop, and the mark.
Look at Greg's smile at the end of this. By the end, he says, pull, drop, mark. Come look at this real quick. You pull the pussy, you drop the pussy, then you mark the pussy. They're like, Greg, cut it, cut!
Pull 1/4.
The pull refers to the number.
Yay,
okay, hold on a second. Pull 1/4, pull 1/4. 1/4.
Pull 1/4.
That's deceptive too. It's never that, it's always just like, pull 1/4! Doesn't matter.
Yeah, no, it's angry. You could literally meet the woman and she'll go, hey, how are you? Welcome to Waffle House, what do you want? And they'll have a nice conversation the second she turns around.
All right, I need a sirloin on 3.
Be 2 people in the restaurant. Yeah, pull 1/4. That's the vibe that you get in a Waffle House, not
pull 1/4.
Pull 1/4.
The pull refers to the number and type of meats to be cooked. Pull 1 bacon, for example, would instruct the grill operator to pull 3 strips of bacon from the refrigerator and place it on the grill.
Pull 1 bacon equals pull 3 strips of bacon. So now...
Yeah, why don't they just say 3?
Now they're getting into their own math. You're gonna really see how archaic and weird whatever these things actually mean.
These numbers refer to the number of orders to be cooked and not necessarily the number of pieces.
Not necessarily, so there's other orders where it does refer to the number of meat being cooked. Holy shit. 1 portion? Bro, I feel like at that point just say 6. I need 12 bacon.
Of meat. While you pull 1 T-bone when pull 1 T-bone is called, you would pull 2 pieces of pork chop when pull 1 pork chop is called. Because one order.
I feel like that's complicating things for the people that are doing the cooking.
Order of pork chops is actually 2 chops.
1 equals 3.
What? Yeah, one is what? What's confusing? About
1 is 1, 2, and 3 at the same time.
2 is 1. It doesn't just mean 3 across the board. 1 represents different numerical values given the pieces of meat. Like, there's no way that can actually, like, help you save time. All right, he said pull 2, so was pork chops in deviations of 2 or 3? I think it was 2, okay.
How well a steak is prepared does not need to be called in at this time, unless that steak is rare or medium rare.
If you go to a Waffle House and you order a medium rare steak, I'm gonna be like, what the fuck? Like, why? Can you make that medium rare for me, sweetheart, that Wagyu you got on the grill there? Definitely not the frozen commercial grade.
The frozen Walmart sirloin that they just got that's been sitting there just out in the open, not in the refrigerator. Yeah, can I get that medium rare? I see there's a few flies on it. Would you mind seasoning those with that?
A steak that you can probably have had in the bottom of the freezer for however long. Can you make sure that thing is just barely pink for me, sweetheart? Thank you.
This is where the magic marker system begins.
This is really why I wanted to get out of this video, was the magic marker system. I cannot stress enough how archaic this system is. Greg, take it away.
As the salesperson calls in the order, it is your job to begin placing markers on the plates using the special code that Waffle House has designed to help you remember exactly how everything is to be prepared.
Greg even looks disgusted by this process. Too. Greg does not.
What, she just pulled a slice of cheese and put it on top of the jello?
Look happy that he has to be talking about this. The magic marker system is they use Waffle House.
Oh my god. So they know where it needs to go. Plain ham, sausage, bacon, medium rare, and rare. Bro, but like, how do I know? What if it's like, what if I put the ketchup packet right here? Then how the fuck do I know where it needs to be?
Plates, various condiments and toppings to show what the order is. The person will tell you the order and the person will dress their plate for the order. Not give them the ticket that you write on. You.
Dude, being a chef at Waffle House probably sucks. Oh my god, you can't just get a ticket that says 2 bacon. They say 2 bacon and then put a ketchup packet and a fork just stabbed in the middle of the ketchup packet. What does that mean? What is that, your new cook? Oh, that means a sirloin medium rare with 2 slices of bacon on top, an over medium egg on the side, and then 2 slices of wheat toast buttered. That's what it means? Yeah, okay.
You dress the plate in sign language to understand how you're supposed to prepare this order. If a toast is plain, they have little signatures of how you're supposed to orient stuff on the plate to remind yourself, oh, there's no butter on this. Not read a ticket, because I guess there are they?
So then they put a piece of onion on the side of the plate. Oh, that means no ketchup. That means they don't want their bacon salted. Oh, okay.
Under the impression that the people that are working here cannot read.
That's what it's for, yeah. It's for people who can't read or write.
So can this not be a subsection for that probably small amount of people? I mean, to insinuate that they're like, we should just make this whole system because there's no way anybody can read or write that is working here. That feels insulting. I mean, imagine walking into a Waffle House and you're like...
Take, if you can't read or write... That might be kind of a problem in the job market in general. I think that's a very common requirement for anyone working is that you are literate and able to read. Not even read like hard words like soliloquy. Like read like bacon. To bacon.
Like you're in the back. All right, so go ahead and cook me this order.
MR, medium rare.
And the guy like looks down. It's a slice of cheese with a couple pickles on top.
Who can't read or write? Don't get me on this rant, dude. Don't get me on this rant. Don't get me on this rant. Percent of United States American adults are illiterate. 54% of United States American adults have a literacy level below sixth grade. 21% of American adults 18 or older are illiterate in 2022. Illiterate not meaning they can't physically read at all. It means that they can't read above a certain grade level that would constitute them being able to read certain things. 14% of U.S. American adults are functionally illiterate. 19% of high school graduates in the United States can't read. Zach for the sub.
Pop inside a back.
Meaning. Actually, I don't know. I was going to say that means there's some people in this chat that can't read or write. But I don't think they'd be able to find my channel if they can't read or write. I don't think they would be able to Google something. How'd they graduate? I don't know. I think that statistic's still skewed. I think I remember when I went on a long rant about this, I think it's like 5% of U.S. American adults can't read at all. And then the other bit is like they have the reading level of like a second grader. So they can read like very, very basic sentences. Like stop, go, you need to do this. I'll be there at 7. Right? Like stuff like that.
Pack of mayo. What am I looking at here? He's like, this is a turkey club. Ooh, are you sure you are supposed to work here?
We call the system magic because our customers often do not notice the markers on the plates and think you have memorized all of the orders that were being called in.
I like how it's like a weird, it's supposed to be like you flexing on the people. Now the people are going to be very impressed that you were able to remember scrambled eggs, hash browns, and bacon. But in fact, you've duped them. You've dressed a plate. You have it marked down so you can remember because your brain does not work that well.
Let's start off by...
You can't read, and you're 35 years old. You don't have any disability whatsoever. You just never learned how to read. So now you place markers at Waffle House.
Marking an order scramble. Simply place a right-side-up jelly pack vertically in the bottom position of the plate.
Wait, what is that for?
Order scramble. Simply place a right-side...
A scrambled eggs gets a grape jello packet?
Up jelly pack vertically in the bottom position of the plate. The jelly pack represents two eggs, which we call an order, and the location of the plate tells us that they are scrambled. With the plate marked like this, the customer is getting an order of scrambled eggs with white toast and grits.
This is gonna get chaotic very fast. One Welch's packet of grape jelly vertically at the bottom of the plate means two scrambled eggs. That's how we know that. With white.
Yo, being a cook at Waffle House would fucking suck.
Toast is what he said.
If the customer would rather have hash browns, you simply add a few shreds of hash browns to the plate.
You're going to take some cold hash browns off the work tray there, and you're going to dribble them on the top of the plate there to remind yourself that there are hash browns there. And once again, you might hear people clapping in the back by how the hell did they memorize? How do they keep memorizing these orders? But don't forget, you're duping them. These are codes that you're learning.
If the customer wants wheat toast, we simply flip the jelly pack over to indicate wheat.
Let's see if we...
Oh, my God. Dude, I had no idea this existed. They flip the jelly packet over and say, okay, that means they want wheat toast with hash browns or home fry. No, hash browns and two scrambled eggs because it's on the bottom of the plate.
What happens if we throw in a butter and a mustard pack? Let's say that you find one of the customers extremely attractive. Well, you can indicate that with one of your buddies without having a sexual harassment lawsuit looming over you. We're going to take two strips of bacon and a pound of honey.
If the customer wants a slice of Texas toast, mark the eggs with a jelly pack and place a slice of Texas toast or a biscuit on the plate to remind you that they prefer to have Texas toast or a biscuit instead.
So couldn't you...
Why not just put Texas toast for Texas toast? Why don't I just make the toast and put the Texas toast on the plate? I have to mark the plate with Texas toast to make sure that Texas toast goes where the Texas toast needs to go.
Okay, hold on. If you're already putting the bread on there, why not just put the white bread? Like, why not put the wheat or the like raisin bran? Why does a Welch's great pack have to be indicate fucking the eggs?
Some folks like to have their toast unbuttered or dry. In this case, we have a special
one. In this case, you're going to cook a hamburger. You're going to put the biscuit back on the grill, right? Or not back on the grill, back on the plate. My apologies. You're going to put the biscuit back dead center. You're going to slice that bitch open. You're going to place down a hamburger patty, right? Then you're going to dress it with tomato, onion, lettuce, and a little bit of Italian dressing, and right? And maybe some ajou sauce if you wanted to as well. And that's going to indicate to the chef that they want theirs buttered, all right?
Mark, to remind us to hold the butter. Easily enough, it's a butter packet underneath the jelly packet like this.
So by putting a butter under the jelly means no butter?
Putting a butter under the jelly means no butter. Okay.
Oh. What? Why not just put no butter? Why not put butter if there's butter? Putting a butter means no butter? Butter should mean butter. Why does butter mean no butter?
Well, put this off to the side. This means nothing to me. I put that off to the side.
So what if a customer wants double toast? Easy. Mark the eggs and then put an addition.
Easy. Okay, so you're going to go out. You're going to find the nearest ocean. You're going to catch a blue. You're going to catch a bluefish, right? You're going to clean it, and then you're going to cut its head off, and you're going to put that on the plate, right? After you do that, you're going to look over at the chef, and you're going to give him a double thumbs up, right? And you're going to ask him for a 1-2. And that means he's actually going to give you 4 or 5 pieces of toast because that means he got a double order.
Additional jelly pack beside the egg to indicate the extra order of toast, like this.
That was easy. You know what? Thank God the basics came easy to me, Greg. Thank you so much. Also, at any time, if you walk in a freezer and you see a containment of alcohol, don't touch it or I'll break your fingers and I'll fire you immediately.
While most customers order 2 eggs, occasionally a customer may only want a single egg. In that case, we'll mark the egg.
In that case, you're going to break the plate in half. You're going to cut the jelly packet open and you're going to squirt it all over the plate. And that's going to let the chef know that you only need 1 egg.
Appropriate position to show how the egg is cooked, and then place a ketchup pack below it. Here you can see that I have marked a single overlight breakfast.
So 1 egg indicates a ketchup pack under a Welch's. I would love.
This is like the dumbest thing in the world. Who the fuck? You know, somebody that couldn't read made this. Somebody that actually was illiterate had to fucking come up with a system. Why is this a thing?
Love to see just one of these full and a guy just being like, all right, toast with...
Dude, this is fucking hilarious.
Waffles. it's like a full plate of like intricate designs and shit.
In other cases, a customer may be hungry and might want 3 eggs.
Mustard packet.
Here's an example.
Because the mustard, it's a +1 metric in the, okay, makes sense.
If the jelly pack indicates 2 eggs, then
why not just put 2 jelly packets? Oh my God, because what is 2 jelly, I already forgot. What does 2 jelly packets mean? I already don't remember. They're doing a jelly packet and mustard to indicate more, but what does 2 jelly packets mean? 2 jelly packets means extra toast. And the regular bacon.
How might you mark the plate if a customer wants 4 eggs? That's right. You use 2 jelly packs stacked on top of each other like this.
Like I said, that's right. It's just someone's like, you stack the Welch's jam packs together? He's like, of course you do. See, it makes sense.
You're catching on quick.
Also, you put it in the center. You need to put it at the center of the plate to make sure that they know that it's 4, because if you put it on the bottom, that means that there's an active shitter in the Waffle House. And a small place like,
if you put a mayo packet in a mustard packet on top of it and hand it to the chef, that means that you're being held hostage and you need help ASAP. It means that the person that you're serving is actively pointing a gun at you, and there's nothing you could do, because if you say something, he said, and I quote, I'll blow your fucking brains out.
It's like Waffle House, they would be like, there's an active in here. Guy's like, dresses it up, and he's like, Karen.
One of the most popular ways to have eggs at the Waffle House is scrambled. So let's talk about different ways to mark scrambled eggs.
I love Greg's smile, dude. Greg kills me with this.
M. Durrell for the 500 biddies. Tyler for the 4. It's way easier for non-illiterate people than people with common sense. Valorant for the sub. Bob for the sub. And Zach for the sub. G. Will for the 3. I can't read or write. I just use voice to text. Finny and Gwenuti and Freaking for the sub. I honestly don't believe you. Full throttle for the five. Been a fan for ages. Thank you for putting a smile on mine and a lot of other people's faces. Thank you. YX for the five. Alrighty with that.
The smile. Let's talk about different ways to mark scrambled eggs.
He has a Joe Biden smile.
So let's say your wife's divorcing you. You're trying to hide some of the assets so you don't have to pay as much in alimony. Well, how would you mark that down so she can't hear you while you're talking with your lawyer? Let's grab two packs of ketchup and a bottle of Tabasco sauce and figure it out. Let's assume your wife's been cheating on you for several months, and you want to hire a hitman to come and basically snuff her out. If you're paranoid and believe that your phones are tapped,
you're going to walk up to the Denny's worker, and you're going to let them know by doing a regular Waffle House scrambled egg sign to them, right? You're going to stack two grape Welch's packets on top of each other, and you're going to give them a double wink, right? Not a blank, a double wink. And then they're going to know, and you're going to meet that guy out in the back, and you're going to hand him a bottle of Tabasco sauce. And then he'll know that you want to kill his wife, or you want him to kill your wife.
Your wife is trying to catch you in one of these misdoings.
Keep in mind, you're not actually going to pay him in real money. You're going to give him Monopoly money, and then you're going to go to the bank and withdraw $500, because that's how much it costs. Very cheap here at Waffle House. You're going to go to a gas station, and you're going to deposit that money and buy Bitcoin. With that Bitcoin, you're going to actually exchange it for Dogecoin and then withdraw USD again and then give it to him. And if you don't do that process, trust me, he'll know.
Go ahead and open up your window and put four cans of baked beans on the ledge. Then you're going to put a small bottle of Gorilla Glue to indicate that the time is ready to stick to the plan. The bounty hunter's outside like, okay, he put the fourth can of baked beans. Let's go!
It is important to remember that the customer gets one slice of cheese for each egg. To make this a triple scramble cheese, you add the mustard pack below the jelly pack to make it a triple and add a third slice of cheese.
Add the third slice of cheese because there's three eggs now. Okay, it's making sense.
You also want to tear off a small corner of the cheese and place it on the top of the marker to help you remember that it comes with cheese.
Tear off a corner of the cheese! There's three slices of cheese! On the plate. Are people just gonna be like, why did I put the cheese on here? Remove a corner of the plate and put it on top. Why? What for? Greg, there's three slices of cheese on the plate already.
Wait, are they implying that the cheese on the plate already means there's not gonna be cheese?
No, because he said that
this is what you do to order. No, this is what the waiter's gonna do when you order from them.
Cheese already the amount of cheese should correlate with how many eggs it's ordered.
The customer gets one slice of cheese for each egg.
So if you had two eggs, no matter what, you're gonna get choose.
So if I order like seven eggs, the waiter or the waitress is just gonna start mounding slices of cheese onto the plate. Then what the fuck do they do after? What if I go, I don't want cheese on the eggs? Do they just throw out the cheese slices?
Two slices of cheese, whatever. You put the grape pack on top of the mustard, which indicates three eggs. Do you have three slices of cheese? Why would you need to cut off the corner, Greg? I mean, how dumb are the people that it's like, you probably went outside and smoked some crack, and you're probably gonna forget that these slices of cheese are even here. For muscle memory, go ahead and just tear off the corner and put it on top of the Welch's grape.
And include an upside down mayo pack to indicate light. And remember to remove the marker before you take the plate to the customer.
We used to leave the mayo packs on it just for shits and giggles because we like to put one over on the customers, but some guy ended up getting stabbed three times in his face. So we'd like to make sure and remind people, take the mayo pack off or you could be deader than a doorknob. But now that you know how to read and call out orders here, we need to make sure that you
there's no way this could get worse.
Understand how to safely prep food at Waffle House, which I'm very intrigued to see because I have seen some heinous shit at Waffle Houses. I've seen someone take out a hose and spray the floor and kick the food scraps on the floor underneath the ovens. I've seen that with
bro, they are that dirty though. They are that dirty. Like, yo, they just want to go home, man. They just don't even want to clean that shit up. Just kicking it under the oven.
With my eyes. I'm very curious what to see what Waffle House corporate has.
You're eating your chocolate chip waffle at 4 a.m. The one cook just wheels in a garden hose and puts his thumb over it and just starts spraying the shit out of the floor. You're getting sopping wet. And you're like, dude, what are you doing? You look down, it's just covered in food. He just starts fucking mashing it under the fridge. Why not put it in a trash bag? Shut up!
In store for us here. The four cornerstones of food safety.
Hi, I'm Brian Literal.
And I'm Carl Smith.
Brian Literal? Brian Literal.
And we want to welcome you to the four cornerstones of food safety. Did you know over 9 million people a year are sickened by the foodborne illness?
That's a great way to start it there, buddy. Hi, welcome to our food safety video. Did you know 9 million people a year get sick from eating food? Probably our food, but we like to try to skirt that number. There's like a transition out.
But as many as 55,000 people every year require hospitalization because of foodborne illness.
I should have been hospitalized that one time, I think. At Chipotle, I was out for a week. I think it was probably longer. I was.
Did he undo the burrito?
So much. Oh, it was the worst, man. My asshole was so chapped. Anytime I tried to sit down, it was like painful. Bloody shits. Oh, it was the worst. And I've gone Chipotle since then, too. When will I learn? I don't know. I don't know when I'll learn.
And over 1,000 people die each year.
Over 1,000 people a year die of a foodborne illness. What if I would have died from Chipotle, dude?
That would be insane. And I would make a video on my channel.
My boss died from being food poisoned.
To protect the Waffle House brand, to help ensure that our customers have a great Waffle House experience, and because it's the right thing to do, we take food safety very seriously.
Feels like Brian is going to cry off the side here. He's like... Brian's getting flashbacks to people like throwing up and like having heart attacks at his restaurant. He's like... We take food safety very seriously. Sure, dude. Honestly, how many times a day do you think at a Waffle House does someone like drop something on the floor and they like look around and they like put it back up on the plate?
If no one's looking, 5 a day at random Waffle Houses, somebody drops a pancake on the floor and just picks it back up. If no one's looking at like 4 in the morning.
Yeah. Oop, dropped my cheese.
Yeah, exactly. Ooh, I was tearing off a slice at the corner of the top and it fell on the floor, but 5-second rule.
Just like a house has a foundation with four corners, our Waffle House way of service and production is also built on the four corners of food safety.
Good personal hygiene.
Good personal hygiene.
Yeah, you must bathe.
You gotta bathe and be sure to wash your hands.
If you come in and it seems like you've been stench maxing for more than 4 days, we can't let you have a job, okay? You're going to have to go in the back and take a sponge bath. You get one warning. 3 days of stench maxing is perfectly okay, right? We'll be able to get through that. The customers might not know. Outside of that, you're gonna get fired. For you, for the sub, to dirt for the sub, Weber for the three. I want to get into philosophy. I was reading some of Friendship Teacher's books. I'm wondering if you have any recommendations. They finish Fix Twitch Mobile, Big Dub. Messing full for the sub, Joshy for the three. Sadly, only just arrived. How's your day? Good. How are you? M. Durrell for the 3 and the 5. Tyler already read that. If you want to read philosophy, I always say starting with Plato's Republic's good. That's what I always say to people that want to start. But if you already read Friedrich Nietzsche, I mean, you could read like some Schopenhauer, see how you like it. Nietzsche likes and doesn't like him at the same time. It really depends your opinion on Nietzsche. If you did like him, then you could read things that are similar to him. And philosophers that are similar to him. Otherwise, you're going to kind of have to go into a different path. Like, you could read, like, David Hume if you're more religious or something of those lines. And Lee for the 3. So I told a girl I like her. I'm going to do school, text her on Friday. Her boyfriend, her on Friday, and her BF and I did not know she had one, started, told me to stop texting her, and ow, he will tell me the whole school, what do I do? What? You didn't know that she had a boyfriend. Say, damn, bro, I didn't know. And then that's end of story.
Hands, and if you do end up smoking meth or crack, wash your hands when you come back, please.
Controlling time and temperature, preventing cross-contamination, and cleaning and sanitizing.
I went to a Waffle House one time. I remember it was like right after we...
Brother, you just started following me. How are you this bad of a chatter? What's your stupid fucking question? Holy shit. Yo, what's your dumb question? I got question. Bro, hello? Like, I have to reply to you. Like, the gall. Like, dude, you realize I don't see every chat that happens. I only saw fucking this one, and then I click on it, and you get mad at me because I ain't read your chat. Dog. Number one, I didn't see all of them. Number two, there was a chance I could have seen none of them. Number three, even that I did see them, what the fuck do you want me to say? Oh, Langino, you have a question. Let me pause my stream. What's your question, Langino? Sorry, I'm so rude for not responding. What was your question? What was your question? We are waiting. They haven't typed anything. Valorant for the four. What's your favorite movie? Also, I don't have one. Have you seen the new Alien? It's fire. No, I have not. Andy for the three. Hello? Are you here? Bro, hello? 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 Bro, hello? See, this is shit that I'm talking about, bro. Motherfuckers get mad at me, then I answer them, and they don't respond. All right.
We got done eating, we were like chatting. This is probably back when I was like 21 or something. We're all laughing and he's like, oh, you know, whatever. And then we noticed the guy at the grill was like, it was really busy in there. It was like probably like 11 at night. Not a lot of people working. And the guy working the grill was like going really fast. He was sweating profusely. And we noticed that his sweat was like dripping all over the shit. He was like flinging the stuff. I mean, like the fucking sweat was going down in the hash browns and stuff. And we all just like went outside and my friend was like, whoa! And like made himself throw up.
That was me at Papa Murphy's. I was on a come down on acid and I was still a little high, but I was just sweating over the pizzas. Just training new hires.
Ew.
Coming down from acid working at a pizza place. Just going,
okay, yeah, you gotta, all right, so you gotta,
You gotta roll the dough, and it's just dripping, and it, the sauce and the cheese. Okay, I gotta go, and then he's fucking run and jump out of the window, just fucking dip.
Did you still wrap him up and sell him?
Yeah.
You sick. Good God.
For women who prefer the Waffle House headscarf, or for those who prefer the visor, a hairnet must be worn underneath. Men with short hair can also wear the traditional Waffle House paper hat.
I don't think I've ever seen anyone wear a hairnet at a Waffle House ever.
There's a video of Waffle House employees like cleaning their hair in like a pot that they cook in.
And she was washing her hair in it?
Yeah, and like, well, a guy noticed because he's like, his friend started gagging and he pulled out like a long string of hair.
This table isn't ready yet to seat the next customers. It has to be sanitized.
The amount of times I've sat at a dirty table at Waffle House because they just haven't come and gotten the plates have always been funny. Like, let me clear that out for you. And they like grab the shit and they just like wipe it once. Like, what do you want?
Can I get a Sprite?
Yeah. Like, off. I'm like, we're in for a beautiful ride, aren't we?
I hope you've enjoyed our presentation on the four cornerstones of food safety. Food safety is an important part of a great customer experience.
Listen, I have never worked at a Waffle House, but I can tell you that I have not seen any of those displays. It seems like it's a little grody, if I'm being honest. We know how to receive orders. We know how to cook them safely and cleanly. Now, let's prepare ourselves to deal with the clientele that comes in. You know, you're not going to get the most favorable clientele, but you have to deal with them anyway.
They sell hamburgers at Waffle House?
Oh, this music right here is so sick. This makes Waffle House feel like a very magical place. Also, the older aesthetic, like back then, and like a VHS kind of feel, fits way better than all these new clean cut videos, dude.
Hello, and welcome to Waffle House. And welcome to the position we call the Dora Corps.
It's so crazy to me that, like, instead of just being, like, as a manager, you have to orientate people. They're like, just play the fucking video. Have them sit down and play the video. They'll be fine. You're just, like, sitting in the back. Welcome to the Dora Corps.
If you're energetic.
Do you think every Waffle House follows that weird ketchup packet guide, though? I feel like the majority of them probably just tell you to do whatever the fuck you like, just give them the fucking order.
A team player who
may say it out loud.
possesses that ability to think on your feet. In all your life, people have always said that you're the friendliest person they've ever met and that you really know how to make people feel at home, then you are a kind of person.
What if there's a guy who's like, no one has ever said that to me? Also, I'm supposed to think on my feet. Am I answering a door and saying hello to people? Goodbye, hello, which one was it? Sit anywhere you like. Oh, God.
Being a team member in a Door Corps is more than just a smile and a quick hello. As you'll see in this video, you have to be a juggler, a smooth talker, an Olympic sprinter.
A juggler, a smooth talker, and you need to know how to commit a couple of war crimes. All right, let's get it going.
And an entertainer.
There's like a one leg.
Bro, you just say, hey, where do you, how many? Three? All right, go sit over there.
Disabled guy, he's like, I don't think I have what it takes to fill this position.
I think a professional appearance is vital at the door. I'm talking about neat, clean, well-groomed, enthusiastic, great attitude. After all, I'm the first.
I should do a YouTube video where I just go to like four Waffle Houses at like 3 a.m. and just film. Yeah, can I just film the food, see how it works? Did they ever ask the question? No. I'll check one more time, though. I literally never asked a question. Ken's for the sub. Going for the sub.
First impression of Waffle House a customer gets.
They had to have gotten rid of this position. I have never been into...
Applying to a Waffle House? Oh, my God. Yo, you could work at a Waffle House. I'd work at a Waffle House for a day. Oh, I'd be so stressed out.
To a Waffle House where some...
Three bacon! You say one. Pull one. Pull one for three. And then you put two fucking ketchup packets on each other and four slices of cheese. I damn near thought you needed me to make every fucking egg we had in the fridge. He only needed two eggs.
Someone is like, that's their job, is to be like, oh, come on in. Never seen that.
Hello, welcome to Waffle House. Hi. How are y'all doing today?
Fine,
good, good. It'll be just a minute before you...
Never had it. I've been to Waffle House like five times. I've never had a doorman. I've always walked in and they've just been like, yeah, sit down. I've also only gone at like night.
Table's ready. So why don't you help yourself to a cup of coffee over at the coffee bar?
Okay. Right.
I guess like behind him, there's a sea of open tables. Your table's not ready yet. Why don't you go ahead and help yourself to some coffee over the coffee bar? I'd be like, nah, just stand. I don't want any coffee. All right. Well, no one's ever neglected the coffee bar before.
Well, now we're at an impasse, so I guess you're just going to stand here for the next, I don't know, maybe 5, 10, 20 seconds, maybe 5, 10, 20 minutes. I've never had to talk to somebody this long before. I'm starting to get really nervous. I'm sweating through my shirt, and I think I just shit myself. If you could please go to the coffee bar before I just fucking throws up all over you.
Okay, well, no one's ever not gotten coffee before the coffee bar. Could I interest you in the bathroom? Sir, do you have to relieve yourself? What? No, I just want to have breakfast. Okay, well, that table isn't quite ready yet, so this is my space, and I can't have you stand in here, so I'm going to have to really encourage you to sit down at the coffee bar.
Somebody told me when I first started to think of Waffle House like I would my home. That helped a lot because I pride myself on being a good host.
All right, welcome to Waffle House. Take your shoes off. What? What do you mean? Take your shoes off. The floor is disgusting. They told me to treat it like it's my house. Take your fucking shoes off, okay? I don't want you tracking mud in here. All right, leave him at the door. Leave him at the door. I'll take him. He grabs the shoes. They're sitting by the coffee bar. They turn around. The host is just fucking smelling this guy's shoes. Just aggressively sniffing them.
I pride myself on being a good host. My cousin sells crack cocaine.
I would die laughing. I feel like part of me would be like nervous, like he was going to kill me. But I would also think that's the funniest thing in the world. If a Waffle House host made me take my shoes off and then started smelling them.
Cane out of the back of our house, and it is what we like to know as a drug den. I used to be what they called a coke mule, where I would put drugs inside of me and have to cross the border.
And I wouldn't dream of friends dropping in, even for a few minutes, without having them sit a bit, offering them something to drink, and something good to eat.
This is so southern-coded. I was just like, it's just that good old boy hospitality. I wouldn't dare have someone come into my house without offering them to sit down, pouring them a drink, maybe lighting them a cigarette, and then talking politics.
Excuse me, here comes another customer.
Hello, welcome to Waffle House.
That'd be so funny. Excuse me a second. Here comes another customer. Welcome to Waffle House. The guy just comes with a gun and shoots him like three times.
Hello, welcome to Waffle House.
Oh my god.
The people at the coffee bar.
Oh fuck. He's like coughing up blood. The tables aren't ready yet. Have a seat at the coffee bar.
Or screaming in horror. The guy puts four bags of Welch's grape jam on his plate. Everyone who works there is illiterate and a mute, and no one can talk to each other. So people are throwing slices of cheese on plates. He's like, give me everything out of the register.
They open the register. It's just fucking mayo packets and shit. They start signaling. They're like, where do we keep the money? Where's the money at?
Mayo pack. He puts a mayo pack and a piece of Texas toast on the cash register. The guy's like, what the fuck are you doing? I'm gonna kill you. They need to have a training video on how to, if there's an armed robbery. These poor bastards only know how to communicate scrambled eggs and fucking steak. They're gonna be so fucked when someone comes in. So let's say somebody comes in with a 12-gauge shotgun.
It'll be just a minute before your table's ready, so if you'd like a cup of coffee, help yourself over at the coffee bar.
Thank you.
Hey, Brad, we're really going to have you stop sending people to the coffee bar, okay? Because
the coffee bar's getting a little full now, Brad. The coffee bar only fits six people.
We have regular black coffee and decaf. When there's 20 people over there and only three of them want coffee, it makes it very congested. He's like, Stephanie, I'm going to do my job the way that I was taught to do it, and you need to focus on yourself. So why don't you and the other illiterates start stacking cheese and grape packs, and you let me do me. I had the idea of like someone also just standing there all day and like they open the door for you. I understand that it's like, once again, it's hospitality. It's like, hey, come on in. But to me,
it's an unneeded job. It is a waste of pay. It's like in New Jersey, how we have people pump our gas. Like, I'm not going to complain about it, but at the same time, it is not a, it's not a job that needs to be a job. You could do it yourself in as quick of time as somebody else.
B, I'm like, I don't want to be pressured immediately. I just want to like, I almost prefer when I walk into a place and they're like, hey, just take a seat wherever you want. I prefer that. I don't like the idea of a guy forcing me to go to the coffee bar. Because I'm a sheep too. So the guy's like, we're not ready for you yet. And you will have a cup of coffee at the coffee bar. I'm not even a big coffee guy, but I'd probably be like, oh, okay. I just sit down. I guess, can I have a coffee? God, all these fits are great too, dude. This is definitely a 90s video. It has to be.
It's your job to convince each and every customer that it's a short wait. Maybe just a cup of coffee away and speed up the whole...
Yeah, there's no way they still do this same exact fucking method here.
...whole process by having them know what item on the menu they want by the time they're seated.
Like how the coffee bar is them sitting in two small chairs by the window. So go ahead and sit over here awkwardly and look at our menu. It's like, what else do they have besides scrambled eggs and bacon and toast? You're gonna really want to peruse around and navigate your way through this complex but delicious menu.
And you always have to keep your eye on that door. No matter how many customers we have, we don't want any getting away.
Always gotta keep an eye on that door. Tommy, we've been closed for 2 hours, man. We gotta leave. The chef comes around back with like a plate full of like tomatoes and cheese and stuff, and he's like, Planet of the Apes type shit. They'll talk with sign language in there.
When I've made sure that all customers are happy, I'll wipe down a table and seat that needs it, or maybe even get a table ready for busing.
I'm busing.
Helping each other helps keep everybody happy. Plus, it gives us the opportunity to serve more customers.
Man, I kind of yearn for these times too, where these like simple positions had such a dedicated video to it. Because now people would be like, hey, just greet people when you come in and just tell them like it's only gonna take a second. It would be that casual now, but back then they're just like, you are the glue that is holding this operation.
Trying to make you feel better about your job. Without a doorman, who would hold the door? If we didn't have you, who would open the door? I don't know. I don't think we would be able to run this place. So nothing would be there. This whole place would go to shambles. People would walk up to the door, say, "There's no doorman," and they'd walk away. I mean, obviously, we've never seen that because we hire a doorman, but still, that's what we think would happen.
Shit together. By the time you leave your shift, people are going to start calling you Elmer because you're the glue that holds this place together. So now you're not a greet people, but how do you know that you're not discriminated against your fellow employees? You need to have a strong work environment.
Kim, pick up. Kim, pick up. Oh my goodness. Are you kidding me right now?
God damn, dude. It was like 1 second. Kim, pick up. Kim. Oh my God. He like starts complaining. The girl, like the woman's already walking over like, dude, I was grabbing it. God damn. I don't know if she can't hear me. She's ignoring me. She's a dumb bitch. I'm going to slap her around. I'm going to hit her.
Kim, look how slow she's like. Oh my goodness, my hip. Oh, when's my birthday? Oh, I can't see you.
Oh, look how slow she's walking. Ah, my hip. I'm old. I'm so fucking old. Fuck you, Kim!
I wish they wouldn't talk about me like that.
The lighting they have, too. It's like a somber, almost like she's dead.
I wish they wouldn't talk about me like that.
Well, guess what, you old rickety bitch? You're a waste of space. Just die already.
Even though I'm older than them, I can still do my job.
I'm just as good as those other young whippersnappers. Yeah, I might not be able to see well, or walk well, or talk well, or take orders. And a lot of the time I drop a lot of things. And I shit myself on occasion. And I only can work on Wednesdays. And they don't like that. But I could just keep up. Hey, if they wanted to knit with me, I'd be neck and neck with them.
No, you can't. You're a waste of space. You're a waste of life, old prick. You stupid old bitch. Just die already. You're a burden. You're a burden on your family. You know those people who, when you're like, oh, I hope they come visit me, it's a burden every time they have to do it. The kids don't want to come. All the smiles you see when they visit you, they're fake. They're all fake. Because we want to make sure that grandma feels good in her later years. Just roll over and die.
Oh, hey, man. Hey, Danny.
Oh,
take a look at
God.
That. Someone like you would appreciate it.
I don't think that's funny.
Are they playing like Fiat?
Hey, Don, come look at this. Isn't this funny? Just like a gaping asshole. Isn't this funny? Well, I don't think that's funny at all. What do you mean? He zooms in. Look. That's hilarious.
I don't think that's funny.
Are they playing like Fiesta music in the back? I don't think it's funny. Come on, man. Well, you're Mexican. You must love this music.
Oh, come on. I thought you people had a sense of humor. Don't take it seriously. It's just a joke.
Well, you people don't have a sense of humor, dude. God, you're such a wet blanket, Diego. Jesus.
Video clips or telling jokes that make fun of a person's race or national origin is unacceptable behavior at Waffle House.
Here at Waffle House, if we find out that you make fun of anybody for their age, sex, or religion, you have to do what we call the gridiron system, where we clamp your hand in a waffle maker for 4.5 seconds and brand you as a piece of shit, but you earn your spot back to work here. That'd actually be kind of sick. You have to put it in there, and it's like you're marked, but it's like, well, you paid your due, so all is fair now.
I think there's like a 3-mark system.
Yeah, they mark both your hands, and then the last one is they fucking the spatula that's all hot. They get a red hot, and they put it in between your mouth like that, and they give you like a Joker smile.
Hey. What's up with James and the beard? They told me I had to shave my beard to get this job.
I don't know why I get so special treatment. I think it's because he's a Sikh. I don't like those people.
Me neither.
Right next to him, too.
Yeah, why does James get to have a beard? I don't know. That's because he's a Sikh. God. Yeah, I don't like those people. I wish I could grow out my beard so I could get some pussy here at Waffle House. People, I look a lot better with a beard.
I hate working with Gary. He takes so many breaks.
Yeah, I think he's got, like, diabetes or something like that, but that's a likely excuse if you ask me.
Why don't we steal his insulin and see if he really dies? Why don't we take his medication and see if something happens during this 8-hour shift?
Yeah, Gary's like a fat f***ing, I don't know, his, like, blood sugar's all wacko. I f***ing hate that fat piece of shit.
Gary, man, why do you take so many breaks when we work?
I just have to check my blood sugar. Why? What's wrong?
You taking so many breaks means we have to cover for you.
My diabetes is my business. If I have to take a few extra breaks, I don't see what the big deal is.
Honestly, I'd get on the diabetes hate train. Dude, if your f***ing diabetes is acting up that much, why don't you go work somewhere else, dude? People are f***ing, like, fighting in here and stuff. I gotta check my blood levels. I'll be like, get the f*** out of here.
Oh, whenever a fight breaks out, Gary needs to go check his blood pressure. The second people come in that he doesn't want to serve, oh, I think I'm gonna faint.
You're dead, dude.
I work just as hard as everybody else.
Fourteen days, you posted zucchini ago. Have you cooked the zucchini since? Once for the sub, Moises for the sub. No. Tharu, Hum, and Kenzo and Going for the sub.
I work just as hard as everybody else for a fraction of the time. I love all these scenarios, dude. It'd be so fun to act in one of these.
That'd be fun to come up with one, too.
What does it say? Yeah, what if there's a guy, like this Indian dude with a beard, and the other guys are jealous of him? They're like, perfect, write that down. Yeah, what if a guy has, like, diabetes, and everyone's fucking pissed that they have to pick up his work? Yeah, I hate that shit. Yeah, go ahead and put that in there, too. I like to think that all these people are just like, yeah, I hate that. You can put that one in there.
I'd like someone like us to cook my food for me. I don't want him touching any of my food. I want you to do it.
Sir, I'm sorry. Bo's the grill operator this morning, and he will be cooking your food. If that's not okay with you, I'm going to have to ask you to eat somewhere else.
I feel like a more appropriate response is you could just be like, what are you talking about? What fucking year do you think this is? You know, like, I'd be like, dude, go fuck yourself.
Oh, yeah, I'd be rude, dude. If I was a fucking waiter and a black guy was the chef and some fucking old white fart was just like, I need you to cook my food, I'd say, dickhead, you want me to cook your food? You're going to get fucking salmonella. The fuck you mean you want? Oh, you want me to cook your fucking food? Dude, it's 2024. Did he ever ask his question? I mean, we'll check. Nope.
Self leave. Get out of here. I mean, how obnoxious is that? I just want to see.
Yeah, I feel like most businesses would just tell you to leave.
Customer discrimination, real quick.
It's the same scenario as just customers.
Yeah. Yeah, why the hell does that guy keep going to the bathroom? Well, I have to check my blood levels.
Wow, I've been here like 5 minutes. Are you kidding me? No one's even come over to greet me. I know they see me.
Wow, I've been here 5 minutes. No one's even greeted me? Okay, well, I guess I'll just sit here forever then.
What you just saw shows how a customer can...
I walked by. There was no doorman. There was nobody even there to hold the door open for me and tell me there was a coffee bar while I wait for my seat.
And feel like he was discriminated against. Waffle House does not discriminate against any customer for any reason.
I definitely feel like Corey looks like the kind of guy to discriminate against somebody. If I'm in, Corey's just like, what you see here is a lie. That is a liar, folks. We don't ever discriminate. That's just the end of the video.
Oh, excuse me.
Hi, is everything okay with the food?
Oh yeah, thank you. Can I get some more Diet Coke, please?
Loud ass soda machine.
Here.
No ice.
I will let you know right now, I have gotten that treatment before. Never taken it personally. Not that I think it's acceptable, but I think it's funny when it's like, if a Waffle House person said here and they slammed it, I'd be like, what a bitch. But at the same time, I'd be like, eh, I mean, they probably have a pretty long day up here, if I'm being honest.
These eggs are running. Can they be cooked again?
And my waffle is burnt. Can I get a new one? Yes, we have to cook these again. People like that get on my nerves. All they want is free food, and they are so rude. I wish they would just go eat somewhere else.
This is Waffle House, not Taco House.
Yeah. That fell out of pocket even for a training video. Looking right at him. This is Waffle House, not Taco House. Comprende, senor? Muy bien. Hola. Yeah, I'll cook your goddamn.
We don't serve quesadillas. Me la me llamo.
And waffle again, you son of a bitch. And then last but not least, the most important of all these training videos is these harassment videos. Roll it.
Hey, Mike. Hey, thanks for sending me this video.
Dude, yeah, ain't it some wild stuff?
Yeah, that's some pretty wild stuff, all right.
What do you think that video was? What if it was cake farts? Bruce was sitting on cakes farting? That's some wild stuff, man. We should send this to somebody.
Oh, hey, let's send it to Joanne.
Dude, yes, get it.
It's just Tourette's guy. It's a Tourette's guy compilation. That Badger song you sent me last night was...
Oh my god, that used to be in my fucking head all day, dude. When did that even come out? I that is like a lost memory. Badger, 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 badger. Mushroom, mushroom. For 10 hours. To a guy reacting is insane brain rot, Joe. I really don't think it is. I watch Papa Meat all the time, and I mean, I think I'm mainly reacting to the video itself and then also what Papa Meat's saying. I think it's enjoyable. But whatever. 1, 2, 3 for the sub, 1 for the sub.
So funny.
What in the... This is horrible. Why would John send me something so disgusting?
All right, it's definitely one man, one jar.
I was going to say, all the headings.
Yeah, it's just beheading. Yo, how do they get the camera quality so good in those, huh?
Hey, Becky, how's it going?
I'm fine, thanks.
God damn.
It's like actually just sexual assault.
Damn. God damn. Hey, Becky, how you doing? Hey, how's it going?
You're the only person that knows the Badger video, buddy. The Badger video has millions of views. Badger song. It has 32 million views. It's from 16 years ago. Oh, my God. That is nuts, man. All right. Lock in. Lock back in, chat. Are y'all mad that I'm reacting to Papa Meat reacting to it, though? Like, fuck. I feel like the majority of the video is the fucking Waffle House training video itself. I mean, I could just try and find the videos of the Waffle House training videos themselves, but I really don't think it's that big of a fucking deal. Bro's like, that's insane brain rot. That's insane brain rot. Like, buddy, I'm not just watching his reaction and saying nothing. That would be brain rot. All right. Yo, but if y'all do have, like, weird training videos from, like, certain businesses, send those in the video suggestion tab, because that would be sick. Like, if there's ones for, like, Chipotle or Chick-fil-A or fucking Chili's or some shit, if you have any of those, send those in the video suggestion tab, game suggestion tab on Discord. Exclamation point Discord. Video suggestion tab, game suggestion tab. It's how I find most of the videos I watch, games I play. Y'all just sent me this video, so that's what I watched. I didn't know there was original Waffle House training videos. I literally just Googled Waffle House training video, and this one shows up, but the other ones that he's watching don't.
Can you excuse me, please?
Excuse me.
I definitely feel like this is something that they turn an eye to, because I feel like I see this kind of shit all the time in restaurants. Multiple restaurants are just being like, you play him. You acting up.
This smells really good. What's that perfume you're wearing? Smells really sexy.
Smells really sexy.
How much do you think they paid the Waffle House workers to fucking film these videos, dude? I would not be doing this shit for free.
See your perfume. It's Tag body spray. Yeah, no wonder you smell like a teenage boy.
You know, I love looking at you. You have such a hot body. Let's go out sometime. What do you like to do?
Sorry, but you're not my type.
Oh, come on, gorgeous. Why don't you give me a try?
What part of no don't you understand?
Look, when I see something that I want, I usually don't stop until I get it.
God damn, being that thirsty at a Waffle House at like 8 a.m. God damn, girl.
6 in the morning, the sun just rose.
How bad. She's going to Walmart afterwards, like Axe body spray. That's her. That's her. Oh, shit.
I wish Pam would stop hitting on me and just do her job. When I say no, I mean no.
You cannot have the actor in the background doing this the entire time. You're down that bad at your shift?
Unwelcome sexual comments or advances to an associate in an unwelcome manner is forbidden.
What if Vika was like, that was kind of hot?
Do they really need to make a training video for that, though? Like a fucking full-length 10-minute video? Where they provide, like, multiple examples? Remington for the sub.
Two girls talking about Axe body spray and getting it on is kind of sexy. I mean, what's the big deal? I mean, can people not just get along? Cut it off. Cut the recording. More of the story is Waffle House is an anomaly. It's a dangerous place. The amount of videos online of people fighting and doing all kinds of dangerous shit is appalling. But I will say, it's a beacon of the American dream. Dare I say, it's probably one of my favorite restaurants of all time. Nowhere.
It is a good ass fucking restaurant. Like Waffle House, Tate, oh my God. Well, I mean, just any breakfast place in general is fucking amazing. That was a W ass video, though. I really enjoyed that. For the dickhead that said I was reacting to a video of reacting, fuck you. All right, now we're watching Creeping People Out at Denny's.
Yes,
bro, how does he do... Bro, for 38,000 views. Oh, my God. You would have to pay me like $5,000 to do that. Creeping People Out at Red Robin. Dining alone in a restaurant, creeping out the elevator. Guy sniffs bloody fingers in Home Depot. Oh, my God. Captain Van over for the sub. Remington Jack, 1, 2, 3, 4. Wooden Bobat for the sub. Gaby Sir for the sub. Zucchini for the three. All right, chat. We're going to call that there. We'll watch another one of his videos another day. If you have any videos you want me to watch, games you want me to play, whether it be training, more training videos like Waffle House or just other fucking random shit. Video slash happy game slash chat. It's high five most of the videos and watch games I play. So if you have any videos you want to watch, games you want to play, send those there. Outside of that, chat, I will be live tomorrow at 3 p.m. EST. We're going to be doing some of the new Fortnite season, then random games with chat, maybe random sim games, some other shit. Tuesday, I'm not live. Wednesday, we're going to be doing a horror stream at 3. Thursday, I'll be live at 3 doing either fucking unbans, random games, and then we're going to be doing Concord at 5 for like 2 hours, so it'll be a half and half stream. Friday's going to be Reacts at 3. Next Saturday, I'm not live. Next Sunday's Reacts at 2. Next Monday, we're going to be doing Roblox at 4, and then we'll go from there. Bacon for the sub. But yeah, if you have any videos you want to watch, games you want to play, as I said, find those there, or send those there. And if you have any funny videos, I think the Try Not to Laugh tab is open for another few days, so you can send those there as well. But yeah, hope you had fun watching once again. I had a fun time streaming. We had a great chat right on. I say a lot of people on the stream. I'm probably going to post on the main and the gaming channel today, probably on the main first. But yeah, I will see you tomorrow, 3 p.m. EST. We might be at the new setup room then. I don't know for sure. But it was a W stream nevertheless. Appreciate everybody that popped in. It was a great stream. Who do we want to raid? Let's raid King Wolves. All right. See y'all then. Hope y'all had fun. And I will see y'all tomorrow, 3 p.m. EST. Be there, be square. We're going to slowly start streaming later each week in the weekdays until we are back to our regular 4:30 EST weekday schedule and 2 p.m. weekend schedule. But yeah, catch y'all then. We're going to raid in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Goodbye, chat.